Let's just recap a few points. I hope that I am being heard clearly for the audience, those listening. I wouldn't know the response, but the members of the legal team would follow and let us know. Let's recap what we have done so far. And Mr. Diallo, help us to come to a conclusion, just like we did before the break.
Mr. Diallo,
you have accepted that Jammeh ordered the assassination of Ousmane Sylla and the junglers attempted to kill him.
With due respect, sir, I said it's Jammeh's words against somebody's words. So Jammeh never tell me give orders for the execution of Lawyer Ousmane Sylla.
Yes.
Kunga funu nyame. Jammeh la kumakango lom anin solba jila kumakango. Yo bitung nyimoflo la kumulu yole ofo ya itandi ko bitung ko lata wole nyama bari mofula la kumombije.
And for Al-Ma'mumane, your position is he was killed legitimately in action.
Andung almamo mane ra ko ya fa kulto me alon ko mangol me alon ko akite da maltema.
So a point of rectifications in the military, we say rules of engagement. So if almamo withdraw a weapon and then these people are armed, whatever happened there, rules of engagement come in. So almamo unfortunately happened to die in the due process of rules of engagement.
Baribitu silang almamo la ko ko sojaro la sartol yafanya makafuko rules of engagement nin ko tata ke hanu foy benta kenanin kené almamo fana yekido le bondi woto wokidi bondo nin ayatra nin menu benta o nya ya bun wokono woto mo safono afata kelole kono me yalonko anin dolle benta keloko.
You see, these matters are usually decided in a court of law. Unfortunately, it's not usually left only to the military. It is left to lawyers and judges. I can tell you that even in your rules of engagement, this is murder.
Rules of engagement.
But we have recorded what you have said. It would be considered. And those who are to make decisions on these matters would do so. Let's just agree that you say that the rules of engagement permit his killing.
Rules of engagement.
Okay.
Sir, yes, sir. Let me comment, sir. If, with due respect, sir.
Ha, ning konga fanyaming ha, animbu nyaning horomo kang.
If people take arms and ammunition and when an attack is staged are being branded as heroes, I think those who went there to make sure they make sure the constitution of the country has been followed and stopped him or whosoever it is, I have also the right to say they apply the rules of engagement. That's where I'm talking from, sir.
Mbeme mfoka wanya ko sarto ya itandi nyaming. Nimmo sorunta me ya lonko. Ay jorangota banko kama laman sakunda kama. Adu mole fanali bijemeni ya lonko ibe ila lotanka wanyi purka banko kanda wala purka wokulu noma sata. Bitu ninku wana atake wokono. Kunga afu nyaming wole msarto tika afu mena ko rules of engagement. Amunta nama rifota ni wala wokono. Bitu wode.
Mr. Diallo.
Ni matra mogne tido sikala itana ka man sa kaboy kam man sa kunda kan ka wo bonni je mol be sila bi ko wol ubi rolleti so wa sa bo fa ni modo fa modo bu ta kata ka fa be na man sa le bokki la je anatana ke a ni o tuta je wol fa nan is a legitimate like ka ko de that is rules of engagement have been applied.
Ah, bolem bolem nyindi ko amunta afata ko kono nyaming amunta sarto lu fanali ala ndi nyaming wala kata daliloti me yafa.
All right.
Yes, the reason why I'm saying that song is that, yes. The reason why I'm saying that because Alma Mo, the difference between Alma Mo and Landesane, from what I heard, Landesane threw a grenade trying to run away and escape. This guy pulled out a weapon towards the other group. So obviously, you wouldn't give him the chance. There is no warning for the shot in there. This is close contact. One have to go.
Yo, between Kokwal Nataka and Yame, Hani Landesane from Nakonia Jube, at the left of Borla Lumpurka Boji. Yo bitum wo kono le fanamu menye keta anata ke ate fananna wayri etelu amunta ninkumu ibebe e wo selakilu ngala kanga etelu nimmo fulolo.
Mr. Diallo,
Almamo and arrest landing, the mission was arrest all of them.
Yo amunta ila hamu nyelti nundo ko amanka ko be landinda mamuta le lafta etelu mo fulo bele mutalo nu.
Okay, we won't enter into a debate on that issue.
Yes.
You have stated your position. It's noted.
And let me make this clear, I was in there.
Exactly. Yes, but your position has been noted.
Yes,
sir.
Okay. Haruna Jamme. Yaya Jamme ordered his killing.
Yaya Jamme le kangodi buru yafa.
From what he told me, because of what Tumbul told him, and it coincided all the animals were dying.
Yes.
I only fanyed ko Tumbuli kumo menfae katu alabula fengolo wale mnyimbe yangoluti ulubebe faka nung andu inata kumo menfae wale yosabu.
And Jasaja Kujabi is the same thing.
Andun Jasaba Kija Kujabi onyakin onyamala.
Correct?
Yes, sir.
Ha.
Okay. Masi Jamme, it's the same thing.
Masi Jamme ofana onyakin onyamala.
Could you answer now?
Yes, sir.
Ha.
And Sise Bujiling?
Sir, I was never present in all these things. It's a hearsay.
Yes.
Sise Bujiling. Nyimbe mu kumaleti ya memfanyi.
Sise Bujiling nung.
Sise Bujiling too. So,
yes, sir.
And these are all confessions by Yaya Jamme.
And you be mu kuma kanle me alonko Yaya Jamme from Sondala.
Yes, sir.
Ha, Asonta.
Okay. So for now, we have four clear murder cases by Yaya Jamme, and one attempted murder on Usman Silla.
Silang mo nani me alonko yolle fa anu be. Yaya Jamme le yamaro di wala gani mo kilim me yalon ko habi wul silo wulindita kama pour ka fa wala Usman Sillat.
So Almamo Mane has not been counted,
but Almamo Mane mo konti.
Yes, I wouldn't count him as someone being murdered. I would count him as someone who take away arms and ammunition, attempted to overthrow a legitimate government.
Yes.
Na wala nyinde Almamo ni aje nga fuko mate konti nim moyo jorango ta kido nin keso purka mansakunda boy ndi membe siring woto wo mari nin kunata kala alao fero lukono wodalilo le yasabu nko sartolu lanya wala yate fa.
Okay, so now we agree we have four clear cases of murder by Jamme and one case of attempted murder, depending on whose statement you answer.
Mona ninga wala soro meni ya longo ulbe fara nu ya jamela ya moroko re fara wolo aning kili me ya longo ye hamu ulinda kampur kafa bari anarna kana.
Okay. All right.
So
now,
can I re-say this, please? One thing I want to say here again.
You are not there. It's all hearsay.
Itenunje abe mumela mumela kumole.
I was like a son to Jamme. He called me son.
Yes.
But this is between me and the country and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
That's
whatever
right.
Whatever I'm going to say here, it's not going to be to favor Jamme, neither favor whosoever. I'm not here to please anybody, but I am here to tell the truth between me and Allah and the Holy Quran. So let me make this crystal clear to every Gambian who is watching.
In fact, that is the reason why we gave you the Quran to swear. So
we
won't ask you to say anything that is a lie.
Yes,
all we ask you is to speak the truth, the 100% truth. Okay. So now let's go to the other killings by Yaya Jamme. Of course, there was the killing of Ndongo Mbup.
Farofa na nsora nda menketa Ndongo Mbupti.
Sir, we've never discussed that, sir.
Yes.
Nene nama okacha.
Okay, fantastic.
Rare.
How about Solndau and Mahawacham?
Solndau dungani Mahawacham.
I've never discussed that with Jammeh as well. I think those people they are killed when I was not even in the country at the time. I left the Gambia in 2010.
In fact,
but you were here in 2005 when Daba Marena, Ibulo, Alfaba, Aliou Cisse, and Mandrafi Kor were callously executed.
Sorry, 2006, March 2006.
Sir, yes, sir.
Ha.
And they were ordered killed by Yaya Jammeh.
Anu Yaya Jammeh le ya marodi purieva.
Sir, yes, I can explain in detail, sir. If you give me the chance, sir.
Ah, nsi ofanan satanole natara yesilo dinna.
Please go ahead.
Tenten yavo.
Let me start with this.
Ah.
Go ahead.
Billahi.
Aha.
Wallahi.
Uh-huh.
Tallahi.
Mm-hmm.
What Malik Jatta said about me there, he is lying, sir.
Malik Jatta,
I have never ever handed anybody among those people to them.
Nene mammo muta wolu kono wolu hani killing ka muta ka fo ka di jamela.
In fact, I traveled with Yahya Jammeh to Mauritania on that day. I was not in the country at the time.
Mr. Jallo.
Yes, sir.
This story is fairly long. So let's try to condense it. Please go ahead.
So when the news broke in Dakar, in Mauritania, there's a coup plot back home. I was the
oddly
at the time, so Jammeh came call me inside the house. But before this, I used to have very disturbing dreams, and I keep telling him, sir, there's a bizarre, I don't know where it's coming from. So he called me to say, you see, what you've been telling me all along, it had happened today. There's a coup plot back home.
Bari ñing jann nga ek nga de wun ko lu soto nga sibo sibo manewlu la bari la kuma la bango de maiko drop tale kote kay la kuma la bango lu.
He called me to tell me what you're telling me is true. So Daba was there, Musa Jammeh was there, and Tumbul Tamba were there.
Ay nkuma ndi ka foko ngey mem fanyi to nyala katu Musa Jammeh bije
Daba
bije Tumbul Tamba fanam bije.
So what happened was like according to what you Amade they were out there what Daba book information. So instead of telling Jammeh, he told Tumbul Tamba.
Bitunkuwa na atakenya mbiringa nyinkuwa ufindita. Daba mamfemfem fuya ya Jammeh, barai kumanyi kumaka unyinchika ayafu Tumbul Tamba le.
So Tumbul Tamba, instead of waiting for them to dig the information, he went straight away and told Jammeh.
Tumbul Tamba fana mpuru, janin puru kanyinkibaro bonyoto ka jube. Ama okere, ate isilo le mutadronga tata Jammeh.
At this stage.
Intembena.
Was Tumbul in the very good books of Yaya Jammeh?
For Tumbul, ani Yaya Jammeh benum kulun kilina bang.
No, because Yaya Jammeh, in fact, if you look at it, he changed Tumbul from Kanilai and put Ibulo there because he came to understand Tumbul was doing so many things that he didn't ask him to do, and then his name was being tarnished in the image of Gambian people.
What money are you be? Yaya man la Tumbul la fang kato anata falin ne fang kanilai ay Tumbul bondije anata ibulo kije kato tumo ininjeta ko Tumbul abulo na da akakujama letamandi meni alonko imanke kuluti menu sahata.
That's what we call occult missions. He do missions on his name using Yaya Jammeh's name.
Akawuli akafansunkuo lutamandi me yalonko Yaya Jammeh bukaba kalama bari ataka deng Yaya Jammeh tolela. Kafoko anganyin kukarika ya munda yale akiala.
So he removed Tumbul and put took Ibulo there.
Wala na Tumbul mume obondije ay Ibulo sa indi ala palasoto.
So when this thing happened, so Tumbul Hafsah and Win James confidence, there was a confrontation between them all in Busedia, and then I was with them, to be honest, because
bitum bri woketa Tumbul fanambe fero membeke kan wolem nyintiko pour aniya jamesina dia lanno e muru itema bitum ko nyin nata ko wala nyama hanfon na nyim murtani takono e nyin kolu nata sangara la wala nyama.
That's why I said earlier, if you look at it before the coup, Yahya Jammeh wanted to disband the junglers because so many things were happening that he never gave instruction to.
Bitum ne ajube hani janni o fango Yahya Jammeh ku jamalu be ke kanu nyin jongla so la karola men ya lonko Yahya fango buke bo e kalama andu buke bulala.
So tell us about the Dabamarena issue. Go ahead.
Yes, Dabamarena ku fonye
ba. So when that confrontation starts, Salif Kor name was mentioned.
Sane bringa kumo fota ina ta sane fango to fanam fojele.
Salif Kor or Malafi Kor?
Salif Kor and Malafi Kor. So they were saying the Salif Kor. That's where the confusion started.
Salif Kor and Malafi Kor bari be Salif le foka num wole lu nyoto nyin nati.
And I told them no. Salif Kor at the time, I think he was in Sudan. I said he's not even in the country.
Wala nante nata foyenko hani Salif Kor atakeno la utikati wotembo wobe Sudan lenga foyenko Salif Kor hani Bangkokang.
But Jammeh was very furious with Daba. I'm saying Daba before telling Tumbul, why didn't you tell me? And Daba was saying, sir, I wanted to dig into the information and know before I give information which is not correct.
Briya fa jamme ya kamfata daba kamabake akoda bay ite nyin kibaro soto munan na ibafula Tumbul tambaye imanna kibaro nyin dinte fangola ya tumbe daba kan ko ha namana foye lefta ko nyin jube lele nga koto jube fo nsi kuma ko yo soto tonya nsi na ofoye janni mina kuma nyin satale mammen kalamolo.
So to cut story short, this is how we came back, and then we were escorted with the Mauritanian special forces. They also came with us.
Bitum kupuruka kwa suti ya ndidron, aketatene. Bitum kwa nata kwa nya utumole untolifanalu nata seinang. Babirin seitana mfanang itulmeni ya lonko lano mankela. Bitum mbele tata nyola ya lulu samba, lulu tata wole nyama kasa hii ya lulu.
Andu senek murtalin kola special fengo wole nseindi.
Murtalin kolu wole fengo wole nseindi nang ila fansum ferola.
No. Ni be plane killing. Ni be avion killing wolo.
Ni be plane killing wole kono.
In fact, I remember because at the time everyone was like quiet somewhere with their counting bits, and I said, listen, why do we have this mutating here? We are soldiers. We are commandos. We go in. Those who will die will die. Those who will survive. I said we don't need them because they don't even know who is who when if it's just a fight broke up at the airport.
Yeah, very bitum nemen nata kidi amoti wala na dolu yinyum foko muna na nyilube kafulama jang. Kadun molu bentul fanalu kono jam menu musojaro uti menu mukomando uti. So muna yosabu puru niye na nyola abeko mintu ambunta ko wole bentul dandang kanang. Aha, yeda mbula menfo airport la kuoto.
In fact, I call Aliou Cisse, Jammeh asked me to call Aliou Cisse and ask him to man, I think the airport together with Faring Sanya.
Yo, wadalilo ya sabu ya Jammeh nte kumanda ko na Aliou Cisse kumandi pour wonim Faring Sanya wolu sikulunti la jidu la nyum muta.
Because Aliou Cisse was someone Jammeh trusted and he just see him like a son. He liked him more than any other person at the time.
Katotumo Aliou Cisse fanang anin Jammeh temo lanna bale bije andun Jammeh ya mutale fanko adingo.
So when we arrived at the airport and then we all went away, so Jammeh, myself and other people, we came to the state house, Sirimonu Jaya received us at the airport.
Bitum birin na tamfutata kuluntila jidula tumobe tate ya bitum te Jammeh ani mwokote ngulunteli tata nyola kata state house.
So when we arrived at the state house, Dabamarena came up, he told Jammeh, sir, don't worry, I'll get to the bottom of this. But from Tumbul's body language, it's like, he wasn't very comfortable, and then and Jammeh went inside. It's just when you went inside the building, there's a small corridor with Daba, and I was the other. I was going inside. Tumbul followed us there, and then he wanted to listen.
I don't need you, baby. Bring from the state house. Daba, you know, for Yaya and Kosa, Ninko, Mbe, Akon, Noma, Satala, Hanfo, Nabula, Nafuta, Dangoma, Kuomen, Ketaje, Bari, ni ajube tumbulu dal e akoni mansono yate bulu kato hanin bedunna bungo kono tumumen na purkata diamu ate tumbulu bulatan normale nyin kamala pur asalo membita fola.
So we went inside and then there were so many telephone calls here and there.
Mbe konoto jede bari telephone kumandiri jamal leketa kumandiro lu fason jamal lu botakara jamal la wolu ketale otumo.
And then Tumbul find this as an opportunity now to get closer to Jammeh. He organized his jungler groups.
Otumo lem Tumbul fana e fero soto purasi nakika kata jamela aya la jongla solu fana la kolu katandina nyola otumo le pro anisi e lo kapare kolula.
So here the Gambia is in a dark position where there was an attempted coup d'etat.
Your mic has dropped. Yamire, ila mic jube.
I said, so he took advantage of the situation.
Ninom kolu fana lu lañati abota nyoto nyami.
So in fact there was a problem between Al Musa Jammeh because Tumbul, according to Musa Jammeh, people have been arrested and beaten in town.
Yo wala la fana Tumbul fana ni Musa Jammeh temo amantra diari mbake katu tumo moli soton tamen ya lonko e ketam moleti melu muta sate kono
ibe boute kan
nyungle hay tumo ibe boute kan.
And then Musa Jammeh found that that's not right, and then he went and told Tumbul, let them stop it. If they want to beat anybody, let them take them to NIA and beat them.
Tumbul le Musa Jammeh tata Tumbul kan akay ni membe ke kan ten amam bete ala bula ni lafta momondi mbute la ye muta ye samba NIA e sine bute woto.
And then make sure before they beat anyone to know whether he goes he is part of it.
Andung ay nyum fanam fayen ko al namano momondi lipa fanan ali feroke ali ya long fodun tonyato nyanyi mari dabijele fadati ji.
So Tumbul called at the state house. I received this sweet boy. He said he want to speak to Jammeh, and he spoke to Jammeh.
Tumbul and Tumbul found out a commander of the state house switch board auto. Bitu akala fita diamu la Jammeh, bitu ntelefona nga shabu, hanifu anin Jammeh diamu ta.
When they spoke, Jammeh called me and I quote, he said to me, say who is it? I said, yes sir. He said, tell Musa Jammeh to bring his tail back to the state house. Tail, underline the word tail, that's its word.
Watumo le Jammeh kama di ntefana na koya afo Tumbul taba ikaye munati.
Aya
fenyo akasa afo Musa Jammeh ye, aya fenyo nati state house. Kuma kango amunta ate yafo nte wanyala kumusa Jammeh sa afenyo nati state house.
So Musa Jammeh being my boss, I just asked him, Jammeh said, you come to the state house, allow Tumbul to be there. So when Musa came, he said to me, did Tumbul call you? I said, yes sir, he did.
Bitum watumo lem, birim Musa Jammeh nata nyim kumo memfanyanka yanko hatuwa nyala Jammeh ko, ite na Tumbul tamba situje ayetentenga bemena.
Musa said to me, say who, this man don't know what is happening, Tumbul is misleading him, and then Tumbul doesn't want the whole truth to come out, this is why he don't want me there.
So Tumbul lem, Musa konye he sehu, nyim mantara tonya fokang abe filindirole la, wadali lole ya sabu, amala fi prunte etaraji, puratis ki kontine kuolu la lafta menkela, mole me ya lonko abe filindirole la tende.
So in between, and then for everybody,
bitung watembo la eko,
For the body.
And other NIS, then we start having their numbers and we are calling and passing calls to them.
Utumolem kumandiro lube kekang, ukumandiro lube nufanalo nime kumandiro kenga la kumandiro soto, yesulata mena isa jensi la kumandiro lufutandi olumari oluma.
And then one fine morning, and then Jammeh asked me to call Daba Marena. But before he called Daba Marena, a civilian assistant Tamba did call there.
Lunkilin somanda Jammeh konga Daba Marena kumandi bari jani ufongo bekela asistamba ayafanya mpurunga kumandi
asistamba ye kumandiro
sorry asistamba ye kumandiro keje
he's not telling the truth. Harry was constantly in touch with Jammeh
ako utumo lengwe nyimfo enko amantara tonya fokan katu juma Harry
ali. Nko na hari moy la même faut dire baraman to afo yam a commissioner hari ni ya jame be diam kan nunne
ngotumo le hari anin ya jame be diam kan. Okay abetata moli amoy.
So and then ya jame spoke to Daba and then he hung the telephone and then I could hear him shouting and he hung the telephone.
Utumolem ya jamenin daba diamuta. Bari diamo nyinto awurita kunale andumbiro botala dronga e telefono nyinkuntu ayadeng.
So until in the evening around 5-6.
Bitunga tatawul nyale fukata wuraro katatala lulufutala woroma afangola.
The communication between them is very high.
Bitun chokinyolo idamangulu tema asembo warata bak.
Between who and who?
Jumani jumatemo.
Between Yahya Jame, Tumbul Tamba.
Utumo Yahya Jame ni Tumbul Tamba tema.
At Harisambu.
Anin Harisambu.
And then the around 5-6 a.m. this morning.
Bitun wosomo tala lulu kata tala worokan somanda juno.
Tumbul Tamba called the switchboard to tell me, to tell Yahya Jame to mission accomplished.
Tumbul Tamba ya kumandiro ke switchboard oto. Kafo Yahya Jame yanko, yembula doko mena ngakele ngambandile.
So I said to Tumbul, what mission is that?
Nko Tumbul ya mundo kule muwoti.
I'm sorry, Council, I do not wish to swear, but I have to say direct as it is.
Please go ahead.
And then Yafo.
Tumbul said to me, just fucking tell him, mission accomplished.
Tumbul ya kumaka umemfaya wole mnyintiko kaya afote nyame ya kaya. Afaya mko nga doko nyinkele nga bang. Aya kumaja wole fangfa aba afola tumumena.
So, yeah, I told Jame and Jame asked me to tell Tumbul to come to the state house.
Biri mfana ngo kumaka usindi Jamema. Jame nyumfanyo kunga afu Tumbul ya kong aine danku state house.
So when Tumbul came, I went down. He asked, instructed me to make sure I open the gate. No one go. Let me go and open the gate for Tumbul.
Pirin Tumbul nata ye kamo din telefono la purunga ta bunda yele aye. Utumbul ente fana njita ntata nga bunda yele Tumbul ye pura ye dunang.
Tumbul came with a video recorder. That's something that record a video.
Tumbul birabe nala anin video recording ne nata. Birun wo video aniwole nata nyola purkana state house.
Yes, so he went inside, right inside the bedroom, inside Jame sitting room.
Utumwole atata kadum bungokono Jame la sidu lato.
He stayed for a while and then next minute they called me to come down and help him with a lot of bag of money. Big, not, I'm not talking of plastic bag, a bigger bag of money.
Tum atasajele fo wati sutum ina tante kumande purunga jiduma ngata makoiroke kodi boto nyim kodi boto bade purunga makoiroke kawo kodi boto nyim chikandi.
Yes, while I was helping, I did hear Ibu judge testifying here. He said he was there. Unfortunately, he wasn't there. The steward on duties was Lamin Makode Jame. He's in the UK here now. Ibu was never there.
And Biringa moye jajube sede ya rola jang akate bijele nu. Barimbenyu mfula kwa atijele nu nde saing membijele nu ibu makote jaju wole bijele nu.
Jame,
wole bijele nu. Adun saing wofango abe Amerika le amantara jang.
Abe Angalter.
Abe Angalter, okay.
So when Tumbul was going down, he said to me, say who, nge kalol filile. I said to him, who? He said to me, you will hear it on the news.
Birin Tumbul beji kanduma ayina fanye ngonge kalolu filile nkae juma konye ba mwele kibarol tole.
Can you tell us that in English?
Fanye tubabu kango roban kafanye kalolu filile.
That simply means we have done with them or we have destroyed them.
Okay.
So he continues saying, he said because he have to come because if not Jame was going to do like what he did to Sana Sabali. To lock them for some time and release them, but this time round he makes sure Jame will set an example.
I know for bitunkuonu latanu nyaming menketa sana sabalila wamukuleti bewele jibari saying Jame be kukela me yalonko wele bekela senti yongoti dolu nyako to dolu nyanta menjela.
Sir, Tumbul is dead, but this is from his old mouth. He said he have to convince Jame to make sure an example is set. Because if not, what happened to Sana Sabali? Just to lock him for some few years and release it, what's going to happen. And then, but this time, he have to set an example.
Tumbulu fango adakalo ye memfonye, abe lakiral barbitra ye memfonye wole mnyintiko. Sana Sabali ye nmenuke, nga ojele watambita barisila njamenya nta santi yongo lekela. Kakuke me yalonko dolu saje, sininsamo isi hakilo utuwato.
Let's put it in plain terms.
Silangake kenebaro.
Yes, sir.
Are you saying Tumbul told you that he convinced Jame to kill Daba Marena and his group?
Fo ika mem fo wala nginti ko ya Tumbul Tamba atele ya Jame sondino pour kay Daba Marena do ñoo ko tangul ke befa.
Well, this is from Tumbul's word. He said you have to make sure Jame set an example. But I'll come in detail.
Ha baride Tumbul fo la kuma kangol lo nginti de ako ate lafta jelale yaya jammeye santiyongo kenyi molu laka kweitandi brunying kamala molu saji.
Because after the death of Tumbul, I had a conversation with Jame, and Jame said to me, you know Tumbul, if I said to him, sir, Tumbul was sick and you never helped him when he was admitted at VIP block. He said to me, Seu, Tumbul made me make so many mistakes in life.
Tumbulu bring abanta fo kola ninja mebe kachala. Ngo jamme Tumbulu sasa ata janne bari hanikata jube wala kwa kuke ala kuoto amanke. Jamme konye nko sehu, Tumbulu mumole time ya alonko. Ay kujama leke meni ya alonko aketa dunyoloti. Wadali lole ya sabu.
Ando enfilindi kujama.
Ando enfilindi kujama leto meni ya alonko mbaratela.
He said to me, you know Daba was innocent.
Ay nyumfonye jele kwa ya alonko Daba mamfemfenke.
He said to me, you know why I went with Tumbulu to Mauritania.
Ya ñum fa ñafana yalo ne dalil jumaale ya kendi nin Tumbul tata Mauritania.
He said to me because Tumbul was in touch with was part of this Ndur Cham coup d'etat.
Ako kaatu Tumbulu adabe nu ñin Ndur Cham coup d'etat konole.
So and then he said and he knew Daba was going in deep into it.
Ando alonko Daba be dun kan ka dinka kolu kono men ya alonko wolle be keri notumo.
So the best thing he could do was to make sure Daba will never stop.
Ase menkeno wolem nyintiko kaje ko Daba kana silo soto puruka murunnan
kadiam.
And then Tumbul was not in good time with Malafikor as well.
Adun Tumbul ni Malafikor fana mantara diari nungu tumo.
And then Aliou Cisse was Yajame's darling, because even when Aliou was arrested, Yajame said no, Aliou will never be part of this.
Kadu Aliou Cisse natake moti ya jamme fango lafita melna bake. Kadu hani brie Aliou muta ya jamme fango kole hani Aliou date tarno la nyinto.
He did ask for them to bring Aliou Cisse. He wanted to speak to Aliou Cisse face to face and ask him why did he plot against him.
Anatanyam fana mfoko. Ye Aliou nati kadu ate founding Aliou lafita diamlele nyani nya. Purasa nyinin ka mune ya sabu. Hanu fate fana ya dadu nyinto.
But then it did happen to me, unfortunately. But he spoke to Aliou before they picked Aliou up.
Ha, baribitung amana sotono praning Aliou nyoje. Baraning Aliou nata dia mulede.
Janding ba sambal.
Yes, sir. Because before then he did ask for them to take rams, sheep, or let me say just a ram for Aliou Cisse at the airport when he was at the airport.
Anatanyo mfule fampuriye sa kotongo samba Aliou Cisse uotumo wobe airport kuluntila jiru lato.
So it is in between this, the news of Aliou Cisse involvement come in.
Bitu uotumo le nying kibaro lukafu Aliou Cisse dabije nata finti wokola.
So council, you can see the people being killed are people either in one way, it's either on the tribal line, I think that's the honesty, either on the tribal line or people that had difference with Tumbul.
Bitu ibaje lako. Ye ñilu melu faten si fatam fansole ya sabu wala amunta fanyale fote madron me ya lonka na take kuyati tema wala ñimbe sabu.
When the government issued a press release
prim masakunda ya kibar kaito bondi
saying that
kafoko
Daba Marena
Ibulo
Alfaba
Aliou Cisse
and Manlafikor we are being taken to Janjambure.
Koy be samba kan nu Janjambure le.
And their vehicle somersaulted.
Ila moso moto na na busulum.
And they escaped.
Inatana kana.
Was the government telling the Gambian people the truth?
For mansa kunda meme nu nyang. Foy be to nyale foka Gambia dingole ba.
Subhanallah. May their soul rest in perfect peace.
Amen.
Ani alama ale nemani kafarkeye.
When the killing happened and Hari Sambu.
Birinyim faro luketa Hari Sambu
Ousmane Sonko Tumbul Tamba I had Hari saying General Lantombon Tamba was there, but I will say it here, billahi
Harisambu bedia mukamba utumo general lantombo ntamba bije bari nsinkali ko.
No, ngamu ya ko general lantombo ntamba mbenu njere, dabi njere, mbenu nata state house.
Ha, akonu general lantombo ntamba fanan dabi ukuoko nole.
Abenu state house.
Abenu state house, ha?
Lantombo ntamba was never ever present at the scene.
Andu, wayatara dun lantombo ntamba, anene mume wo mantara wo dinkirato.
Who was present at the scene?
Jumalebe maaberi ni wo dinkiranyinto.
In fact, that early morning, I had Jamie asking, Tumul Tamba, is lantombo aware? And then Tumul was saying, no, he's not aware, he don't know, and then the Jamie said, good, good, good.
Kadu osomanda.
This is what he has said, I was standing.
Osomanda ngaya Jamie mwe akatumul tamba nyininka. Fodun lantombo ntamba bijele bang
faya
kalamuta le bang tumbuluka e hani utumole yaya famfananko yo abeteata.
So who was present at the scene?
Silan jumale be maberen dingiranye ntoje ha
Harisambu.
And who else?
Ninyuma
Usman Sonko, former
Usman Sonko,
former inspector general. And ninyuma
Tumbul Tamba, you said. And who else?
Sir. That was it. You see, I can fully recall. You see, when you come out of the office and go into the main building at the corridor there, that's where they came to discuss it.
Mkoya je dame ya lonko ni finti la bumba nyinkono ibita kan karado la ilao jenjengo la je peron koto ibenta wole to purkata nyinko diamu.
I came down to took Yajame, it was after office. I came down to took the baggages up, some of the luggages up. That's where they were talking about this.
Birimo be kala fante jitana ne pour bagage lu menu ya lonko e tutaduma pour ka wulu chika ke samba ke selendi santo.
What agreement did they arrive at this meeting?
Yimbendula nyindo e benda mun kandela je.
Let them say the customer salted.
Aha, say akan kota ke.
They were discussing, the three of them, and they came to the town to say, let them announce the car had somersaulted when they were taking them to Janjambure.
They were hatching the big lie to feed the Gambian people.
Amuntebe faniyani tara kani ba taka tabi ka Gambian old kau ta kau di vindi ni Gambian wrong moli.
Answer.
Yes sir.
Ha.
Yes sir.
Ha.
And you are saying that Harisambu, Usman Sonko,
yes,
Tumbul Tamba, and Yaya Jammeh, they organized to lie to the Gambian people that this vehicle somersaulted and the five Dabamarena and co disappeared.
Amunde ka men fole nyintiku kabo yaya jamela ni mo me be men foteng e sitale ku mo kacha yaa kambenta kula kana kuma kon fitil gambe dingol ye ka foko nyim mo dulo la men fere kabo dabo mare na nalay molu be samba kan nun jenjamburele e roni nyata jubu abu sulta e kanata.
Could you answer now?
Yes sir, I was there when they are saying it. In fact, because I was taking the baggages up, luggages up.
Ha to nyala mbijele nun katwo tembole mu mbe bagaso lu selendi kanke samba santo.
Who killed the following people?
Jumale ni Molfa nkana nyunu menu foteng.
Dabamarena. Ibulo. Alfaba.
Aliusise.
And Manlafikor.
And Manlafikor.
So with due respect, that is something I wasn't in the books. Like Malik said, I've never moved out even an inch from the state house. I don't know who pulled the trigger. I am just talking of what I see or what I heard.
Ala yalon defo ngokumo tije nun amanke nyala malon jumanyol lem ning alate man siole fono.
But after these killings
rinim faro borala,
you received the call from Tumbul Tamba. And you asked him what mission accomplished and how did he respond?
He said just fucking tell him mission accomplished.
akonga na doko kele ronga bang ainendirofo nga kele nga bang ngambandile.
And afterwards, Yaya Jammeh requested that he come to State House.
Anduwa kola Yaya Jammeh ya kaningkur arpirate fong tumbulsina State House. Monsala kordabar.
Correct?
Yes, sir.
Ah.
And Tumbul came with a cassette of a video record.
Tumbul nata State House jedo anin cassette omea lonko kumakon lebe record ringe.
And the video recorder itself.
Anin video ning.
Yes, sir.
Ha.
And he went into a room with Yaya Jammeh.
Ani Yaya Jammeh naranata bungo dokono.
Correct?
Kodi.
Ha.
And when they were done, Yaya Jammeh gave a big bag of money. Correct?
Ri parete lo kachala ani Yaya Jammeh bungo ngono Yaya Jammeh naranata boro di mealon kabe faring kodola na flo.
Correct?
Yes, sir.
Ha.
And it was after that the meeting took place at State House.
Okola lembengo ni naranasoro masala kordabar.
Correct?
Yes, sir.
Ha.
Wherein they decided to tell the biggest lie to the Gambian people.
Jail to minara na kuwe beta bi minara na kafindi kana fanya ba la findi ndi Gambia dingolukang.
Well, that's what has been said there. Yes, sir.
Ah, but between wala kera yes ha.
Is it lost to you that Yaya Jammeh ordered the killing of these five people?
For Yaya Jammeh asani atemal ko Yaya Jammeh ne yamoro di kunyum. Mo lulu la fala bang.
With due respect, sir.
Thank you very much.
Inumbarabak.
Thank you very much.
Inumbarabak.
But from everything you have said,
but kabo yembefo,
Yaya Jammeh paid the killer.
Yaya Jammeh farlal nying ayejole.
And then he gave him an excuse by lying to the Gambian people as to what happened to the deceased person.
Anarana yamvodi afanna kana findi kafani afo Gambia dingole aning mola mela ngwe la mol fata.
That is the truth, isn't it?
Olem tuonya keso di kodi.
Well, from what I said, and from any genuine Gambian who can understand, this is exactly what happened.
Good.
Konga menfo adun Gambianka wo Gambianka ya fahamu wole mukoti menketa.
So it is fair and proper that we add onto the list for Yaya Jammeh that he killed Daba Marena, he killed Ibulo, he killed Alfaba, he killed Aliou Cisse, he killed Manla Fikor.
Muntabe tilin na la puru moye ni modol fanan tolta ke lafa ni modol kam men yalon ko ay menu fa folo ke nu welen kabo Daba Marena, Alfaba,
Ibulo,
Aliou Cisse,
and
Manla Fikor ke lafa tol kan kota ke ko atele wol fanan fa.
You agree?
Isontale.
So a point of rectification, that word will never come out of my mouth because he wasn't at the killing zone. All what I do know is I was with him in the building. So I will have
But Hitler never went about the streets of Germany shooting anybody, even though 6 million Jews were executed.
Hitler fa manta medo kan le ka mol fa men surtout ka foko motar million woro ifata Jewsol.
Just like you said a minute ago, with all the things you have said, it can only be understood that he killed them. Because they were killed at his behest.
Well, let's put it this way. I'm not trying to defend him here, neither do I want to lie. He never gave me an order to say, tell them to kill them. All what I do know is I do receive a call to say mission accomplished. And I've seen Tumbul coming in there going with money. Yes.
Ha, but ntete kumafola meya lonko, ntel fania lala mola alun nte kumasoto balo fana mfola.
Mr. Witness, let's
kule meya lonko aketa nyami nga sata ngamelong wale keta wanya akobelata wale nyam.
Let us not prolong this.
Gana watu jamfani.
There's nothing to prolong here, sir. You obviously know. I'm not here to say
it. Yes, but I want you to say it. I am not the one testifying.
The mandara na sedi andro di kande itelabadi.
Mr. Witness,
you have to be fair to me here.
Yes, I am being fair to you with everything you have told us. Okay, let me change the question. Yaya Jammeh got these five people killed.
I mol ni soton de yefa.
Are you gone, sir?
Could you say?
I said, can I come in, sir?
Yes, that is the truth, isn't it? He got these people killed. And then he tried to cover it up.
Well, I am the Gambian
people have the right to say, to come up with a conclusion. Well, I'm not going to say, yes, he did it. All what I said, I do receive a call telling me mission accomplished. And I said, I think I've been very straightforward here. And I did see Tumbul coming into the State House, and then he did collect money. So, sir, with due respect, sir, you can make
and decision. And soon after that, they fed the Gambian people what you know to have been a lie.
And nung video bora la narna kibaro bo de Gambia di ngole me alonko ite fo na tan alonko mu fanialti.
Well, whether it is a lie or whether it's not a lie, this is what they said at the State House. Exactly where I was standing, this is what they said.
So okay,
okay.
You could have allowed me to continue a bit.
You have sworn on the Quran.
That's why I have to repeat exactly what I heard, what I see, not to say, yes, he said this, he said that. As long as I don't receive a call from him telling me, tell these people to execute these people, that's not going to come out of my mouth. What I do say and what I do know is I did receive a call from Kumbul. Yes. And this is exactly what he told me. So I'm giving you the opportunity and the Gambian people to come to conclusion. Tell me to speak on behalf of the Gambian and said, yes, he did this.
We agree. We just want to know what you believe.
I think
I have to believe what all Gambians believe, what all Gambians believe.
So just tell us, what is your belief?
My belief
is that they've been killed.
By who?
Jumalefa.
Well, by the junglers.
Under whose instructions? Who directed that mission?
Sir,
who ordered that mission?
If Tumul have the God to come and receive money, I do not need to tell you under whose instructions, sir.
So we can conclude it is Yahya Jammeh's instructions.
That
to come from
no, Mr. Diallo, stop dodging the question.
We've got to be honest, but I swear on the Holy Quran, I gave you the opportunity for you and the people to come to a conclusion. That will come out of my word, from my mouth.
Is this notion that Wahbu Ega Yefi Dofla?
Pardon?
Are you trying to reinforce the notion that Wahbu Ega Yefi Dofla? You don't want to cut the T's or connect the dots?
I'm giving the panel and the Gambian population to come to that conclusion, sir.
Mr. Diallo, you know very well, deep in your heart, that Yahya Jammeh ordered the execution of these five people.
Yahya Jammeh, you know, they sent them to Konoko. Yahya Jammeh, they are already putting him on the list.
I am speaking for those who have the knowledge to understand, and I'm speaking. I think I'm speaking to a very professional lawyer. You are good in your job. That's why, with due respect, sir, that's why I said that. I received a call from Tumbul. I said, mission accomplished, and I opened the gate for Tumbul to come in. And I said, Tumbul received money. You said me to say that Yahya Jammeh give the orders for them to be killed. I said, I didn't hear it from Tumbul. Sorry, from Yahya Jammeh, because I hold the Quran. I have to see what I hear and what I see and what I witness. The rest is just for the to come to conclusion.
But Mr. Diallo, you later sat with Yahya Jammeh.
But Nyato Domani, Akokerun Kola, any Yahya Jammeh Sitale.
And he told you that with regards to
misled him.
Exactly.
Yes, sir.
And did he express regret about what has happened?
Oh, yes, especially with
Deba
Marina, yes.
Exactly. So obviously Yahya Jammeh expressed regret because he did what he now believed was wrong. Correct?
Kodi.
I'll give the panel the opportunity to come up to that conclusion.
Well, put it this way.
Yes, sir.
You would never say that Yahya Jammeh did it. Because you are ashamed.
You don't know me. Don't ask anybody who knows Sehu Jalo. I do not shy away from the truth. I was one person, people tell me, if you're not careful, Jammeh will kill you. I said, he let him kill me, telling the truth and telling lies.
But you are avoiding.
Speaking,
you are avoiding.
Avoiding.
You are avoiding calling the kettle black.
But even body can nanka kunin katonyako.
I give you the opportunity to call it black. So you expect me to say on behalf of Gambians the kettle was black. Why those who want to understand what I said? That won't come out of my mouth. So
well, make me understand. In plain terms, what you are saying. Just a moment. Aren't you saying that it is quite obvious that Yahya Jammeh secured their killing?
Ay ma foko yaya jammi atele ñun la faro ñi atele mar atele fiya ko ñi fanké fewja ba.
I didn't pull the trigger. I don't know who and who pulled the trigger. What I do know was I did receive a call from Tumbultamba saying mission accomplished.
Ntemang kido ta kanyilubum
andu something and then someone come and said, oh, the guy you sent said mission accomplished. I will allow the Gambian people and the panel to come to that conclusion, but not from my mouth, sir.
Bari Tumbultamba lelota ko yetel kimen aketale andu ye bandile bitun silam babula la Gambian ko lubulu itel fangli ye mira ya jube faye hakilo ko no ko nyin keta nyamin.
We would put it on the Yaya Jammeh's docket as number 10 person, as 10 people already killed by Yaya Jammeh.
Ba kala ten ne ko Yaya Jammeh motang ibe fa andu Yaya Jammeh lefa.
You agree?
Isonta.
That agreement wouldn't come from my mouth because when he was given the orders for them to be killed, I wasn't there. All what I said, I did.
Okay, let's put it this way. These are 10 missions ordered by Yaya Jammeh and 10 of them accomplished. Agreed?
I wouldn't say 10 missions ordered by Jammeh. Apart from the one that he basically tell me I'm about CC, the rest are all hearsay. So I'm not there to say they were ordered by Jammeh. Yes, sir.
You know what you're doing? You are huffing and puffing at the same time. You're speaking from
there
two sides of the mouth.
Huffing and puffing in my diary, sir. I'm sorry, sir. I don't have that in my diary. No. As time goes on, you will come to the truth. You all know the truth. What I want to say here, I do not want words to be put into my mouth. I have to be very fair to the Gambian people and say
Would you say that Hari Sambu is guilty of covering up murder?
Hari Sambu
I wouldn't say he was guilty or innocent. I'm saying
listen to the question.
Yes, sir.
Are you saying that Hari Sambu is guilty of covering up murder?
Hari Sambu is not guilty of covering up
murder. Hari Sambu, Tumbultamba, Yaya Jammeh, Ousmane Sonko are all under the same basket.
Hari Sambu, Tumbultamba, Yaya Jammeh,
which is guilty of covering up murder, to say the least.
Well,
they know what Gambians don't know. So you see, if we go further, you will get to know what I'm trying to say. But it's like you want us to stay here for hours debating on this, and then I'm not gonna say things that I have no idea about. I think what I said here
No. It is more like I don't want to say the obvious. And
the
not
obvious is already there. I'm a council. If you send people and then somebody come among them, someone came and said, mission accomplished, and then I said, what mission? He said to me, just fucking say mission accomplished. Next means the person who called came in and received money. And then we came with a video recorder, maybe to show evidence this had happened. Obviously, the panel, I'm not here to say this. You know, every Gambian know what happened there.
Okay, well, we know that Yaya Jammeh ordered their execution and they were executed and he paid money for that. And that's what we know from what you have said.
That's all what you can say, but you want me that word to come out of my mouth? No, I can't. I'm sorry.
Is that a reasonable conclusion?
No, you're asking me to say what I see and what I know. I'm trying to tell you what I see, what I know.
I ask you, is our conclusion a reasonable conclusion?
Well, that's left to the panel to judge. But obviously, you know, Tumbul will not come to that house with a video recorder without being given orders. But I'm not here to say.
And where would those orders come from?
He came to give a situation report, so he came to the president. So whatever happened between them, if people were alive, or Jamie come, you should tell us what happened.
Okay.
But he said, yeah, yes, this, that, that, that.
Okay, okay, let's recap what you said.
Ye men fosila nga murunga nga jubeba.
Jamie and Daba had serious arguments over the telephone, correct?
Yeah, Jamie and Daba, you saba, jau soro telefono.
I wouldn't say serious argument because I didn't hear the conversation. All what I do know is because when you pass a call, you can see the red light blinking. Because then you have to monitor whether you finish talking or whatever before you pass another call. But the conversation didn't stay long, but I can hear him shouting and banging the phone, yes.
Okay, so which signifies that Jamie was angry, he was when, not happy.
Oh, and mentally, well, I'm going to go, yeah, Jamie, I'm comfortable, I'm going to
say, and Tumbul Tamba was telling him, sorry, and at the time, Tumbul Tamba carried out a mission and came and told you and called and to tell you that to tell Jamie that mission was accomplished.
And what or Tumbul Tamba taradoko la commandiro ke kopriya faya Jamie ko doko nyinga timmandile.
Correct?
Kodi.
Let's put it this way. He didn't call me. Because when you say he called me, mean private, probably he called my line. He called the switchboard.
I understand.
Where all comms called to and Pastor Jamie. And I was the only.
We understand.
I wasn't the only there, but I picked the phone and to say, he said to me, tell Jamie, mission accomplished. And I said,
perfect.
He said, fucking tell him, mission accomplished.
Exactly. So he was reporting to his superior, isn't it?
Abe kwenye murunkandi murunkang ala nyaron kole kanu, abara menna.
And obviously, from that conversation, it appeared that the superior knew what this mission was.
Sae wodi amonyi kono waya itandile ko, alawo nyaron kwenye alonne ko doko mumenti.
Correct?
Yes, of course, yes.
And then Tumbul Tamba had to come to State House to produce evidence of the mission accomplished by way of video.
Tumbul Tamba na first in a State House here Mansara Korda Bata in a Kuban de Mian Kolbe said around the member Tandila Kutonya Tonya Tara document Aya Timbandila one of video nyindi.
Correct? Yes, he did came with a video. Yes, he did came with a video.
Okay.
Yes.
And he went into a room with Jamie and they had a conversation, they have their own meeting, the two of them.
And Nunganingia Jametanata Bunkono Idamalu Kachara J Bansum Bengal Surja Damalu.
Correct?
Kodi.
Yes, sir.
Ha.
And immediately after that, Yaya Jamie gave a big bag of money.
And Borum Kola Tariani get on Yaya Jametana Borofata Kadi Kodo.
Correct?
Yes,
Kodi.
Ha.
Yes, sir.
And after that there was a meeting between Tumbul Yaya Jamie, Usman Sonko and Hari Sambu, correct?
Kola Yaya Jamie Tumbul Hari Sambu aning Usman Sonko in Anna Bengosoro Kodi.
And in the meantime, you had asked Tumbul, what is this mission accomplished? He said you would hear it in the fucking news.
And we bring up Bengonim Botala in Anna Tumbul Nininga, Munim Bengonim Adelo Muneta Koyako Bamwele Kibarodole.
Correct?
Kodi.
At that point, that fucking news he didn't hear, he said he would hear it in the news.
Yes. All right.
And he said to me,
okay.
Don't get me. He did say, "Me Carol Philly."
Yes, but he also told you that your people have been disappeared.
Yes.
And you also saw them discussing to say to the Gambian people that the vehicle somersaulted and these people disappeared.
Nuiya mwele fana bekachaka inarna bengosoro ko inarna kibaro bundi ko nyimmolu ibe sambaka njanjambure la muronyin kunna yelemata e Canada.
All put together clearly say that Yaya Jamie sort of read that these five people were killed and they were killed and they went to give a lie to the Gambian people.
Nyin kuma ka olbe ni eta ye kafu nyoma e metan ni wolam nyindi ko Yaya Jamie boto kul nyin kalamala inarna kuma ka muta ya bondi Gambia dingole kafu mole ko nyummole Canada le besamba ka makati wato men waya tawu kuma soro balolete.
Obviously, yes.
Ha, kata wala nyama.
Thank you very much.
Mubarak.
Ha.
No,
all right. Let us move on.
Let me just bring in the two, three short-term questions. Mr. Jallow, did Jamie tell you where Tumbul Tamba told him the five Gambians were executed? The place and what happened to their bodies, where the bodies are? Jamie didn't tell you anything about that?
Nothing, absolutely, sir.
And Tumbul didn't tell you what he told the president also on that, those two points?
No, because it was a conversation between them, never.
And did Tumbul tell you also, Yaya Jammeh tell you, the video clip or the video that Tumbul gave him, what was on that video? Was it the execution, was it the burial, or what was in that video? Do you know?
Sir, I don't know because I have a limitation and it is need to know basic, please, sir.
Thank you. Counsel, continue.
Thank you very much.
Numbarabake.
What even as Dawa Marena and others were killed?
But how can be called Dawa Marena do you know what you have?
And a lie was fed to the Gambian people.
Fania na na tabi kadi Gambian nola.
Investigations were going on as to who was involved in the Nur Cham coup d'etat.
Kisikisiro ni na tenten ka lon jumala benung mabering me Nur Cham lo coup d'etat bayering onyinto.
And many people were arrested, taken to the NIA and brutalized.
Mojamal muta ye samba NIA la san san kono je ye tajireya.
Correct?
Kodi.
Can we finish what they were talking at that point first, please?
Okay, let's go. Let's go back to that. Please go ahead.
Any dingira bam follow it.
So when this discussion was made, Khalifa Bajinka, the late name came up.
Yeah, bringing you the amulukeda Tala Khalifa Bajinka fananto fora.
I have heard what Harisambu was saying. He was this Jammeh was laughing. Harisambu was more in a joyous position than even all those people. I have to be honest. I don't want to be disrespectful to him, sir, but he probably didn't see me when they were talking. I was standing.
Fungal tilinga to nyafa belokong fe Harisambu akatate sewole dia munta nga sewu maleje bringin dia mulbe keka ngo tembot.
Because he suggests, in fact, when Lantombo Amasola stuck for law, when Bajinka name came up, he suggested for them to send military police to go and arrest Bajinka in Nigeria.
Hatu biringo dia mulukono biring Bajinka tofota. At fanga nyine fam foko is military police welem sojaro lu fana kono police olu is olu ki Nigeria pour eta Bajinka mutaji.
Okay, let me ask you this question. On that day or the next day, was there a meeting at State House
for Bengosoda the State House leba
where Tumbul Tamba,
Diamond Tumbul Tamba,
Usman Sonko, Harisambu, and Lantombong Tamba,
Anil Lantombong Tamba,
came together
in Aranyoka Ibenta
to meet Yaya Jammeh.
Kana Yaya Jammeh Tarandi.
This is what happened. I was not an office oddly. I was in the house.
Menketa wole mnyindiko amanka ko office orlio damandi bari mbe bungo kono nungo tumo.
So if that happened, I didn't see any meeting of thought. That meeting I'm talking about happened at the corridor. This is where these people came, but Lantombo was never there.
Nyim kumo memba fo kante nyile nyim bengo ke bantalale bungo jen jengola bitung bari utumo.
Let me tell you two testimonies we have received before this commission. One testimony is that the meeting involving the four people,
Lantombong,
Harisambu, Usman Sonko,
Tumbul Tamba,
meeting Yaya Jammeh,
Kataka Yaya Jammeh Tarandi,
never took place.
Ko anana mansoro.
Is that correct?
Fomu tonyalti bang.
I am speaking what I have seen, and then I am not telling you.
Did
don't
you
believe what they say or don't believe?
Did you see that meeting?
Foyo bengo jele bang ka ketaba.
I am telling you, believe what I'm going to say, and I said billahi wallahi, believe what I said here.
Okay.
I'm going to tell you here.
Okay.
I didn't see a meeting at this office because I was in the building inside the house. But I did saw a meeting between Tumbul Tamba, Usman Sonko, Yaya Jammeh, Harisambu.
Okay. All right.
Lantombo was in there. And I said it before. Okay. Even in the morning when Tumbul was leaving Yaya Jammeh's house, he did ask him, is Lantombo aware? And then Tumbul said to him, no, he wasn't aware, he's not aware. Because, let me make this point clear. Lan Thong Mong, at some point, they've seen it as someone, I do not want to be discipled here, but they've seen him as somebody who is like, you know, it's a reconciliation, but they've seen him someone as like, he doesn't care which tribe you belong to, like everyone is the same. So some of the things that were happening, they have to make sure they push him aside.
And bring who?
This Tumbul Tamba was the center. I said, because he had a friction with Jammeh, this time around he went to meet for Jammeh, he win Jammeh's confidence. He was at the center of everything. Because even at some point, Musa Jammeh was even pushed aside.
Okay, all right. Just a moment. Would you say that Harisambu lied?
Harisambu,
when he suggested,
with due respect, don't even need to complete the statement. He was lying. He lied.
Ani mankumo bamfanga be faniyala nu.
Lan Thong Mong said he never went to State House to meet Jammeh with these people.
Kataka ya Jammeh tarandi ani
nyimulo. I'm telling you, the people that I saw, I didn't see Lan Thong Mong anywhere near there, sir.
Okay.
Amen nu je ngawale fo. Bari Lan Thong Mong nyama jije frank.
Thank you very much. Let's move on. We have a lot of other issues to cover. This one is very important. We know the killings. We have the circumstantial evidence, the indicia of responsibility. From what you have said, we can draw our conclusions. Yeah, Jammeh got them killed. So now let's move on to the tortures that happened at the NIA.
Silangata tajire ya le mialongo wala ka NIA law sanzan kono je.
So first of all here, I didn't finish Bajinka. Well, let me come with Bajinka because I had Harisambu talking. I have to be very honest to everybody here.
Okay, go ahead. But it's not
because
critical,
I I'll summarize it. When Hari gave the idea for Bajinka to be arrested, and then at that point Jammeh asked me to go upstairs. But inside the building is so big, there's somewhere we call Moroccan Hall. I went down and came through the Moroccan Hall to the state banquet and hide under the, behind one of the doors. I can hear them talking.
And what did they say?
That was the time Jammeh said it's against the international protocol to get Bajinka arrested from Nigeria because the Nigerian government wouldn't allow it.
But Bankunim bankute malua balantale puru yeta Bajinka muta Nigeria masa kunda fangote sonnawala.
So when I heard that, I ran upstairs and I told Yusuf, I said, these people, I heard them talking, it's like they've killed some people, but hopefully six of the late news will hear it.
Could you repeat what you said?
When I heard them talking, I ran back to Yusuf Hassan, he was an oddly as well.
Yes.
I said to him, I had a conversation downstairs, but the way these people are talking, it's like they've killed some people.
Berim nga wamoy nimbro le tata santo, ndata Yusufa sana yang kaya ha, ngayon molo mo idea mula le alwa mulunta ko, yamodo le fa baribitum binaki barol mo ilale talaworo kibarol.
And who are these people?
Walam jumalti, nimolti.
Who you believe they have killed?
Ko ilara mena yefale.
That is because then at that time we don't know who and who. I just tell them, maybe we know it in the evening.
And did they announce names later?
Of course, yes. These are the five people you name now.
So right there and then, your belief was that they have killed these five people, and you rushed to Ismail Ajam, Yusuf Ajame, and you told him. Correct?
Yes,
yes, sir.
Between that time and now, what has changed?
Between
that day and today, what has changed?
Well, it came out plain that those people have been killed.
By who?
Kabo Jumala, Karola, Jumala Efa.
By the junglers, and then Yaya Jammeh knew about it, and then Yaya Jammeh knew about it, Harisambu knew about it, Usman Sonko knew about it, Tumbul Tamba knew about it.
Abutun junglers all lay fade, but has Harisambu yalong, Yaya Jammeh yalong, Tumbul Tamba yalong, Usman Sonko yalong.
And a report was sent to Yajame that the mission was accomplished.
Narana reporto murundi Yajame kankafai ko dokoni ngatimandile.
And as a result, you believe that Yajame, Harisambu, Usman Sonko, and Tumbul Tamba killed some people, and that's why you told Yusuf Ajame.
Udalilo kang ilara nyin lako Yajame, Usman Sonko, Harisambu, Tumbul Tamba.
I believe these people have been killed.
No. You said these people.
But council,
just hear me out.
Stay here. We stay the whole day sticking. This is something we've passed. We all have to believe they've been killed. And then I gave you the opportunity to say, yes, that is my belief. Somebody can see it in a different way. They've been killed. And they've been killed. They were wrongly killed. They shouldn't be.
We would leave it at that, and people would listen to the record, and then they would draw their conclusion. So let us move on.
Yes.
So I
went up and tried to call Badinka to tell him not to come to the country because I had this. But Badinka was adamant that he's going to come, so he came.
But in the phone, and
some NIS were sent to arrest him. For some reason, he told them to go back. They are not the ones who are supposed to arrest him. They are soldiers. But then, you know, he was just a lucky guy and lucky to be alive. So I was coming from the laundry. I took Jamie's clothes. I was coming from the laundry. I saw Mustafa Sani. He was saying he had the opportunity to revenge because it was Badinka who demoted him. Yes, he was demoted.
Yeah,
I'm sorry, the interpreters. I have to go quicker because we want to finish this part.
Between Kona and Kenyaming, Olem Nyintiko, Badinka atemumole timeya lonko mantale bentaye. Katu ntefongo nga katale ka kumandi Nigeria ka fai pura akana na banko kang. Bari ay kanja atamandije ako abina lale. Ando ama bay anatale, yo bari bitungu natamolu fongo lubulindile menu ya lonko iko yeta ya muta. Yo bitungu fongo kang nata Mustafa Saneje meya lonko akabala julo jolale. Katu Badinka le moti meya atela palaso jindi.
Yes, because Mustafa Hassan insubordinated second lieutenant Bulli Tamba at the time, so he was charged and demoted. But then now he had the opportunity to say yes, he's going to revenge on Badinka.
Lieutenant Bulli Sane, Lieutenant Olema,
Bulli Tamba,
Bulli Tamba, yo watembo atengani yo beole barbitum anataka nyale mmeya lonko. Itelu ngani yo momenti Badinka dalala le nata mantabe ngai mala ko la banta nyame
okay. Yeah, no ngame ko danko
ta
Bulli Tamba ay jutnele ke lu sorry astaghfirullah Mustafa Sane ay jutnele ke lu Bulli Tamba la inata la grat kilo wo bondi from corporal to last corporal so what wo Badinka len commandati so itole ya sa ate am Mustafa Sane ay jere ko sa ay juro so pour ke jono Badinka ko
ala
la grat wo tinya
okay.
So okay. When that happened, now some people were sent from Badinka, and then I heard them talking. I just rolled up, and then I took the phone because I could not call him with my number this time around. But our German's telephone were all private numbers, so I put the muffler on the speaker of the phone, and I said to him, "Listen, whatever you are doing, leave the country ASAP as soon as possible. A group of coming. If they meet you there, you are gone." So he wanted to know who it is. I said, I'm not there to tell you who I am. Just leave now.
Between the lady, commander lang fason jama lebije barbirin nata na borin tata dulato ngabajinka commandi ngafene mura telefono yin dala puru akananka usute nka enko ibe tembe woto ibe dawo da fereke ye banko bula sain niwonte itabanta ari yinin karo ke kujumalo nyinti barbitum ndeman nawo fae.
That's how he left the country. Thank you very much. That is very important. So now let's come to the investigations that took place that March
2006.
At the NIA headquarters. There was a lot of torture of those who were arrested. They were beaten mercilessly. Correct?
Kodi.
Well, that is a hearsay because I've never ever attended that panel. I've never been there, sir.
Umumwela mwe kumol tele katundene na mama beo panel oto adun malo muneta mataje bari mwela mwe kumolem.
But you had Tumbul and Musa Jame agreeing that Instead of beating people where they were being arrested, they would be brought to the NIA and beaten there.
Baika moyle ena e tumbul ni musa jamme ka kambe nyinda pur molla ke muta ke muta da men ja ikana ili baje bari sinati ena e tajire ya woto kodi.
No, there was no agreement. Tumsa jamme told me that he had that he advised Tumbul, let them stop beating people in town. Anyone they arrested, start beating you from town. Before he said, if they have to beat anyone, let them take them to NIA and investigate. If he or she is guilty, then if they want to torture, they can torture him, but they should not beat people outside, because he's not going to say the good name to the president.
Ni be mo umondi mbute la ye muta ye samba NIA ni itatatara kutonya tonya nyimari ye silo bulale ni be bute roke la je isi bute NIA baria bula purka molu bute sate okono kadu wote president oto diala.
I know you have told us that you are not present at the NIA.
Ngala ni mfonyele kwa imondra mabedu nung NIA.
Did you hear reports to Jame that these people were being beaten at the NIA?
For your report, Omoele, me ya lonko ya friend ya Jame la kafaya kwa nyumu wende ye tajire ya lwa.
All right.
Nani?
Nani?
So we leave 2006.
2006 kuwa nyinga wala ndikarala.
All right. So now, let's take a few steps, a step backwards.
Sila nga simfada ta ngamuru koma domandi.
In 2005,
sa mkono,
57, between 67 and 57 West African migrants came to the shores of this country.
Africa til jindala banku dingomol men bi dafa talul nim feng wa dafa talul nim feng ina banko kanjang.
And they were arrested.
Ye muta.
By the police.
Police wolle muta.
And they were taken over custody by bombardier and members of the state guard.
And menu ye nata ye ta police blo kono katara ila maroto wollem bombarde ani molam ni alon ko be do ko la man sara korda bar.
Tell us what happened as far as you know.
Afonyem bam men ketaw Africa til jindala bam ko dingo molla ko do itala londo re mel lonje.
You see, I was even surprised to see so many people like Lego Flamington and others talking. To be honest, I didn't hear anything about this until years after. Then I was having a conversation with Jame. Sometimes this come up.
Yalo nyinko tembo ntemambo akalama ndo anataka nyetera ngol difang bring lami.
Be careful, you are overlapping with the interpreters. You have to give them time to interpret. Could you say that again, please?
Se akamba.
I said this is something I was never privy to when it happened, to be honest.
Mambo akalama biraketa tumomeng.
I think in fact we do hear small rumors because I work in office. Sometimes something will happen in the state house for 1 or 2 months. I wouldn't even know. I was always with Jabba upstairs.
Kuondo lufungu lukakele, akata karifula nite bukabu wakala makatu wati wati, nite ninjamele katara santo.
Yeah, so because only those who are supposed to know will know. So one after all, I think 3 years after this incident, one day we were talking.
Bitung anata kenyaming, kuolu nibe kela, menyanta melona, ikawole long memanya na melona wobukabu olong so nyinkwolu la karola anatale han fight list ai sanji sabasi wotumo ninja mebe kachaka lunkili.
Yes, so you are watching television.
Albert
telejibe ola
which news?
This lady came up Emma Hass
kiwarjuma albert kiwarjuma la jube kan teleto
which news outlet? Sky News, you said.
Sky News.
Okay,
yes,
proceed please.
Tenda. Emma Hart,
yes.
So, and then I see he changed his face. It's like, he said, I don't like this lady. I said, Dad, why? He said, oh, you know, this lady is always talking, you know, I mean, he never talk good about Africa or especially when it comes to African leaders.
Yo, mbato. Nabe telejibe o langaje, bring Emma Hart, afindi da television to drong, ayanya kuya, akonyi muso nying, ate abuka kukende fu mufinduma, akatu kumakole ngon leo drong, fula mufindula kuoluto. Wala nante ala kibaru abuka nsewo.
What else?
Animu.
So that came in, you know, we start talking, I can't remember all, and then until we reach with these Ghanaian issues.
Bitumo tumole nga diamo damu tang hakilota be mutano lade bari nkachata wole nyama hanifon na diamo atatafuta nyingana nkola kuoma.
And then, you know, sometimes Jame, he's trying to warn me indirectly, but he's not telling me directly, like, always let me be very, very honest to him.
alunja metuatio atinimbe kachala tumodo la karindandalale kumaka ngokono kafanye watu watu inyantale ye hakilotu.
So while we were talking, he said to me, you know, this Ghanaian incident, and I said, yes, sir. He said, this is giving him a big, big headache.
Bitumo dia mo konolom hanfu atafanga na atafoyaje nyingana nkola nyinkuo nyimbe kundi mibale dikana munda ole nyinta ketaye kola ya baleti otembo.
Then these UN inspectors were in the country at the time.
Birinyi UN la nyin kisikisirlal na atabanko ka ngotumo.
So he said to me, say, you see, sometimes when I get very mad with all these people, they start coming and begging me.
Akonye se ho yaje tumodolu nintata hanfo nkamfata modolu kama dolu sibulinan ibina ibendanila.
He said because before this Ghanaian there was a first batch of foreigners that came into the country.
Akotumola ko janni nyingana nkola ko be fola kafu dole folo soton ta melunata banko kan.
Who were known to be migrants.
Me yalonko ya nyilonko wudai lalle muiti.
He said they were intercepted and then they were searched. He said, but could you imagine these securities? He don't tell me who and who. He said, took all those people's money and then they briefed him. He did give Interpol the directive for them to be deported back to their various countries.
Akonye bitunko yajele kolu na atakenya ming. Barinyin security olwe kakuo mendolu ketumololu. Birinyin kafufolo menu na atanambankokang. Yebe mutale. Biriye muta. Yenyin jimolu la kololu bebu usila. Bitumbriye la kololo taibulu utumolo ina taferoke yenyimolo be mutaye fintindi bankokan.
No, they advised, they informed me
ya wakumo utumolo
ya
ta kalamutandie kumonyi mfaye.
And then he asked Interpol to deport them to their various countries.
Nyimfoko Interpol dunia be police kafo nyimpolisi nyimolo murundiye sambela bankolukan.
Proceed please.
Exactly.
Proceed.
So he said, with this other badge,
akonye bitu nyin kafudo,
a lot of money was taken from them.
Ye kodi jamale tanyi lufana alubulu.
And they went come back to him and lied to him.
Alungul nata muru na inata fani afaye.
I'm telling him these people are mercenaries who came to took over his country.
Wolle nata puruka fayen ko ha nyi molumelu ngemudaten masinari wolle masinari wolle molumelu kata keloke kodoye wandung yenyina fayen ko wolu natale puruka na boyin to la banko kan.
And he said, I just want to be honest here. He said based on what they gave him as advices or whatever proofs they have from those people saying they said this, they said that.
And I mem for nungo tumo ko ate yakuma kango menso to nyimolu bulu ye menu na yakuma kango menu sindi atema nyimolu la kuoto.
So it's like because Musa Jame and Tumbul was in between coming and reporting and other people reporting to him. I don't know who, we just mentioned few names.
Amunta mem for nungo nyimolu Musa Jame and Tumbulu and nyimmo kotengolu wolle bina kam pour kana ko molu faya wo moko tanglu maollo mbare ni mo flolu tofole.
He said, say they lied to me and then they made me give the orders these people to be killed.
Akosehu yajele nyilnatale ye fania fonye kuma soto balo yole drom fonye aduna natala banyadi muneketa wolle nata sabu hanu fonyi molu yefa.
Mr. Jalo.
Mr. Jalo.
Yes, sir.
Yaya Jammeh told you.
Yaya Jammeh
yes, sir.
He ordered the killing of these Ghanaians.
Tele kango di puruka ni
Ghanaians.
Africa tri jindala banku di mumulu yefa.
So that they know anybody that they send, he is ready for them.
Aha, but a follow la ila kuma follow la mamwede.
He ordered these people to be killed.
I can't do pure nyilufa, but 11 men for that thing.
By mistake, sir.
Pardon?
If I had said that, it's by mistake, sir.
Ako mufilo leti.
Sehu.
Ako afilta.
Sehu, this is no mistake.
When you then filo it.
He was misled into believing that these people were mercenaries.
Yeah.
That's what he told you.
Yeah, feeling the lame for you. Yeah, feeling the lame for you.
But the first
badge,
he asked them to be returned back home.
Okay.
Ako kafu follow nyin da ya ka nyin le di pour yow lu say ndi la banko lu kam pour Interpol yow lu say.
After eating these people's money, that was all the deals failed.
Akobitum wolan nyindo lubrio la kololu ta brie kololu ta ekomu negeta.
They branded them as mercenaries.
Ukbrio la kololu talem ina tafo ko ulmu mercenary oleti molumen kelo ke kodoe.
And then
And then he told them, because from the information he's getting from whether it's true or not, he asked them to make sure they deal with them.
Sehu, you are changing your position.
He knew about it. Yes, of course. On his orders.
You have said it twice.
Yes.
He ordered them to be killed.
Yes, he said, let them deal with them. And Musa Jami came and said, Ama, let them finish them up.
Ah, koye bitu ye fere kenyil molula. Yo adum nata Musa Jami nata kwafoko nyanta molu finish la ke trobang walam ke laba.
You have held the Quran. Just hear the question.
Yes.
You have sworn an oath on the Quran. You have kissed the Quran several times and sworn to speak the truth.
Just
hear me out.
Let them deal with them. So it means the orders came from him. Deal with them. They kill them from his orders.
Abunta atele kangodi ko ye nyimolu labang.
Okay, I'll ask you the question again. Yaya Jammeh ordered the execution of these West African migrants.
Yaya Jammeh kangodi puru nying Africa trijinda labang kudingo molu yefa.
Could you answer now?
That is a hearsay from him, yes.
So he told you that?
Atale wo fo e kodi.
Well, I do know that he said let them be dealt with, yes.
He told you that?
Ngalon neko atale ko ye manyi molula.
Let them set an example.
Puru ye santiongo yitandi.
And these people were executed on the basis of his orders. No, I am asking if... Okay, but you know that these people were killed.
I do not know, like I said, until when this testimony started at the TRC, I was surprised to see some of the names we name here as part of those who were part of it, to be honest, because it's need to know basically. I have no idea who and who was there.
Okay. Yes, I take it you don't know who and who was there.
Yes,
what I do know is what he told me, that he was being lied to, saying these people were mercenaries. Yes, sir.
And on the basis of that, he ordered that they be dealt with, they be killed.
I let them set
an example.
And did Yaya Jammeh know that they were killed?
Yaya Jammeh yalla nako e faale ba.
How can 45 people or so be killed without knowing if he have already given orders for them to be dealt with? So obviously, the word dealt with, what does it mean? It depends on between him and those who did the execution. The UN inspectors were in the country.
But isn't it the case that Yaya Jammeh just hated Emma Hart because she was busy saying that these Ghanaians were killed in the Gambia? Isn't that the case?
Pardon?
Isn't it the case that Yaya Jammeh hated Emma Hart because she was busy campaigning or raising awareness that West African migrants were killed in the Gambia?
Yaya Jammeh fudu dalilume yaken diko ay Emma Hart kong. Wolem nyinti wobenyi lankene marola kaitan diko. Yenying ganiano lufa Gambia banko le kang wala mu dalilo time yakendi ya jamme malafeni musundi mun.
So as at the time, yes, you were having this conversation with Yaya Jammeh, it was already public knowledge that about 57 West African migrants were killed in Gambia.
Bitun watu meteni ya jamme be okachala nyinketa kulondi ngoleti nyim banko kanko membitala mu talulu ni woro nyong. Men keta nyim mo findu triji banko dinguluti yow lu be fa nyi Gambia banko le kan wolon tale wutumo.
Sir, I was never in the picture of all those things. You'll be surprised because, like I said, as an oddly, some of these things happened you didn't even know. But the UN inspectors were here and he wasn't comfortable with it. But with the revelation from the TRC, he made me know so many things that I thought I knew him very well, on the whole I don't.
Okay. kujamale katamanu utumo meni alonko. Akawati tale fangja nintebe bula kalama. Bari brinti ar arsibe keka njamulu kana ajaika diamu. Utumo le fangu. Ntenatabu kujalama jama kalama. Ngamira numfango konganyi mari ilone. Bari yara utumo mabalona.
Well, we have had the junglers.
Nga junglers olu mwejane.
They testified that they carried out the order to execute these 56 West African migrants.
Nying jongla solu ya fuleko bitu itelie kangole tamandi puru nying mofindula nyintiliji banku udailalu motalulu ni uoro ya tamandi kangole kampuru kawulu befa.
And just a moment, some of the victims who escaped the execution described somebody who everybody knew was Bombardé as being involved in the arrest and execution of these Ghanaians, of these West African migrants.
Mo soton mo lumeni alonko ikanata ni mo findula nyentiliji banko dingulukono. Wolunata melna kumofoko yeo marileje me alonko ye bulola nyin Ghanaian lukang. Wolunata ke moleti kafume ye Bombardé. Andum bitum wale nata ke moti me ya lonko ya te sute ya foko fanang adabe mulu ekonomene ye bulola nyengani yanu luka.
And even the guards who were there testified saying that it was Bombardé and others who came to pick up the Ghanaians, the West African migrants.
Hani kantar la lumenu bije ulfanali ye nyin sede ya rola keko Bombardé nin dole nata meni alonko wale nyin ganan ko lu be ka fu nyoma ye muta ini tata ye samba.
And at this time, where was Bombardé walking?
To fokabula o tambola to Bombardé be do kola no mindole
state house.
Where was Tumbul Tamba walking?
Tumbul Tamba te benu do kola mindole.
Could you answer now?
State house.
And according to Malik Jata and others, it was Tumbul Tamba who gave them the orders.
Comme Malik Jata ya fanyame. Comme Malik Jata ya fanyame Tumbul Tamba ole yamaro di la pour kany molta ke samba.
Katefa.
And after all this, you had all this. And then you recalled your conversation with Jame.
Inatene hakiro murundi koma ni yaya Jame kachal mensoron.
Him expressing regret.
Ateya dalala nimso itandi.
That Tumbul Tamba misled him.
Ko Tumbul Tamba yoya filindi kuwo kuwonyin konole.
By telling him that these people were mercenaries.
Kafaye ko nyimmol mu mercenaries solleti.
And wait, sir. I never said he said Tumbul Tamba misled me. He said he was being misled by security apparatus, but he never told me who and who.
Nanyum foko security le ba filindi kambari man Tumbul Tofu.
Okay. All right. Better still.
Better.
And he regretted the decision he made.
Amunda nimzata kangole simfa dala imenta.
But in fact, what he regretted is the consequence of the decision. Which is that these victims have died. These migrants have died. They were murdered.
Ye fale.
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah. Do you want me to come up, sir?
Well, I want you to confirm that.
Yes, because you said this. When you said I had all this information on the TRC. In fact, I did try to reach out to Bomba, and I said, Bomba, you of all people, what put you into this? But he didn't want, he said, listen, let them say what they want to say, but that's not the truth. Whenever I come, I'll tell them the truth. And I said to him, you know what, I'm ready to send you whatever you need to go and set the light. I said, because I'm very disappointed to hear your name involved in the killing of 40-something people. So, obviously, I cannot say much about whether what Malik said was true or not, because I was not privy to anything that happened there. I only knew this after a few years.
The important thing here is the confession that Yaya Jame made to you.
So many things. In fact, after that, you can see, I told you he dissolved the junglers because he realized so many missions are being carried based on lies.
Okay, but even at that, his hatred for Emahad
yes.
was so deep. That he wanted Emahad dead together with other people. In fact, he came up with a list of people he wanted dead.
Ani molto na me alonko lafta olefa.
Mutual fight.
Tell us about the story.
Utari ko fonyaba.
Yes, because he feel most of the people, those people that you have in your list, were his enemies, and these are people who want to see him down. They don't want to see him in power. So he have to make sure he do everything possible to protect himself against them. Yes.
By seeing them dead. Spiritually.
Kaje ko yefa.
Well, not some of them not dead, because in fact he even made relationship with some of them, but to make sure not like Mandika Kakoka the Kedah city.
Sehu. We had a conversation before.
Yes.
And what you told me is that Yajame wanted these people dead and he was going to fight them spiritually.
Yemem fanyo lam nyindi ko ya jamia ba jelal ko lafta ni mol ye fa ba be kela la nyala me yaron ka be kela ni ndu.
You are talking over the interpreter. Allow the interpreter to. What I'm saying is you gave me a list.
Ye tol le dinna.
Yes.
And you said Yajame wanted all these people on this list dead.
Iko Yajame ni mol me be to ye dinna tenga lafta ni mol be ye fa.
Not all of them dead.
Well, he wanted them dead spiritually. That's what you told me.
And we go after the Yefa ni do kurola.
Not all of them. He said some of them. He don't want them to talk about him again. Let's the UN inspectors. He wanted to make sure this thing will never come out.
Amanke beti de baribitung foko dolu be kono alafuta le purukaje ko. Wulu ikanala kumofo kota ke imanyan la kadia muhanifo ikasi ikate la kumofo.
How did you get the list?
Nimol to ye soro nyadile.
This list was prepared and then given to somebody, and he gave them to some of his trusted marabous, and they called me and said, come and see whether you have any of your friends here. That's how I got the list from them.
Bitum nying ye kaito nying dadale hanfo ya prendi purkadi morola bitum mono ata soto meyen kumandi ha akonya molle tolu filosofirin jande na jube fodum iteri betar la nyilu kono le banga nganyin kaito lu soto ngole nyama.
Because who wrote the list?
He wrote them.
Wale nyin tolu safe ate juma
ya jame my yes the former president
jame meme president otinu jame fangale nyin tolu safe.
Are you saying he wrote the list by his hand?
Yes, sir.
You said yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Do you have the list with you? I have my copy.
I don't have the list, but I think I have a WhatsApp message that you sent me.
Yes.
Okay, you open yours in your WhatsApp and I will read it out from here.
Council, is there a date on the list?
No date. It's just a list of names.
Yes.
So
may I start reading them out?
Yes, sir.
Or maybe you want to read it out yourself. Read it out yourself.
Kukoi Sambasanyang.
Kukoi Sambasanyang.
Panderimbay.
Panderimbay.
Esa Bokarsi.
Read the full name.
Esa Bokarsi.
Esa Bokarsi.
Esa Bokarsi.
Esa Hawa Bokarsi.
Esa Hawa Bokarsi.
Yes.
Yes, read the full name because that is important, huh?
Hold beer for the year for Abdi Safirinya.
Abdoulaye Wade, Senegalese president.
Ani Abdoulaye Wade, Senegal la president.
Karim Wade.
Karim Wade.
Sanabi Sabali.
Ah?
Sanabi Sabali.
Sanabi Sabali.
Sehu Sabali.
Sehu Sabali.
Ousseynou Dabo.
Ousseynou Dabo.
Khalifa Sala Doy.
Khalifa Sala member Doy.
Henry Gomez.
Henry Gomez.
GPDP.
GPDP. Dr. Boro Suse.
No, Doctor. No. You missed the name.
It sounds a model to
Allah. Hamad Ba.
William Dibari.
Hamad Ba.
Hamad Ba.
Hamad Ba.
Hamad Ba.
Uh-huh.
Dr. Boro Suso.
Dr. Boro Suso.
Lieutenant Landin Sane.
Lieutenant Landin Sane.
Baba Kajali Job.
Ning Baba Kajali Job.
Serif Ba Job.
Serif Ba Job.
Pasala Jan.
Pasala Jan.
Ibrahima Ismaila Chongan.
Ibrahima Ismaila Chongan.
Captain Edward David Singate.
Captain Edward David Singate.
Captain Peter Singate.
No,
Captain,
no, no, no. Look at it again.
Ajube Kuba.
I don't know.
Lieutenant Colonel Peter Singate.
Yeah, Lieutenant Colonel Peter Singate.
Lieutenant Colonel Peter Singate.
Tombon Sedi.
Tombon Sedi.
Turo Jaune.
Turo Jaune.
Duta Kamaso.
Duta Kamaso.
Fode Makalo.
Fode Makalo.
Usenu Mbenga.
Usenu Mbenga.
There is another name just in the box created on the right.
Modo Tobe Jele, remember
call SOS Justice Keba Sanyang.
Justice Keba Sanyang.
Next.
Uh-huh.
Samuel Sarr, Minister of Energy Senegal.
Samuel Sarr, Minister
Energy Senegal.
Of Energy Senegal.
Member of Malafengon La Senegal.
Sektijan Gad, is it?
Gajo.
Gajo.
Gima?
Sektijan Gajo.
Sektijan Gajo.
Minister of Foreign Affairs Senegal.
Well, Minister of Member Senegal in Bandala Bankolu Tema.
Uh-huh.
Babukar Bless. Is it?
Ismaila Jain.
Ismaila Jain.
Ismaila Jain.
Babukar,
Babukar Bless Ismaila Jain.
Bless Kampaore, Burkina Faso.
Bless Kampaore, member Burkina Faso.
President Bless Kampaore, Burkina Faso. Read it all.
President Bless Kampaore, Burkina Faso, la président.
Uh-huh. Next.
President Muammar al-Gaddafi, Libya.
President Muammar al-Gaddafi, member Libya.
It is a sec. Senegalese former Prime Minister.
Idrissa Seck, Senegal la Prime Minister Koto.
Alaji Bora, I don't know, Manjang or
Manjang.
Alaji Bora Manjang.
Alaji Manjang. Bora Manjang.
Awad Sise Sabali.
Awad Sise Sabali.
Amina Fall Sonko.
Amina Fall Sonko.
My sister.
Antuman Gay Lawyer.
Lawyer Antuman Gay.
Ablaye Kujabi Dobong.
Ablaye Kujabi Dobong.
Ansumana Kujabi
Dobong.
Ansumana Kujabi Dobong.
Mustafa James Kujabi
Dobong.
Mustafa James Kujabi Dobong.
Alhaji Mai Fati GMC Party.
Alhaji Mai Fati GMC Party.
So the two other names, Sidia Jata and Buru, I think it's a repetition of the first name.
What? Yes.
Sidia Jata, PDOIS.
Sidia Jata, Doi.
And then?
Boros, Dr. Boros, is it Boros?
Boros Suso.
Dr. Boros Suso.
Again, second
again.
Time.
Again, you know, Sinya Flanja, on to be for
and no, Dr. Sirif Sise.
Dr. Sirif Sise.
Yes.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
Lieutenant Bakari Kamara.
Mm-hmm. Lieutenant Bakari Kamara.
Superintendent Malafi Sanyang.
Superintendent Malafi Sanyang.
Mariam Jack Dentin.
Mariam.
Mariam Jack Dentin.
Moudou Kadicham.
Moudou Kadicham.
Madik, is it
Madike? Madike Sipiter Diallo.
Madike Sipiter Diallo.
Yes. Next page.
Kadifula Nyong.
Sabanyang.
Sabanyang, sorry.
Panyelis.
Suare, Panyeling Suare.
Panyeling Suare.
Karamo Fati.
Salikenye.
Karamo Fati, Salikenye.
Lieutenant Colonel Hussein Nour Cham.
Lieutenant Colonel Hussein Nour Cham.
Major Khalifa Bajinka.
Major Khalifa Bajinka.
Zag Zignou.
Juma?
Zag Zignou.
Zach Zignou.
Emma Hart.
Emma Hart.
Peter Gomez.
Go back. Emma Hart.
Can you
Sky News.
Thank you.
Juma.
Emma Hart, Sky News.
Emma Hart, Sky News.
And that was the lady who was busy. Disseminating information about the execution of the West African migrants in Gambia. Correct? Correct?
Yes.
Go ahead.
Peter Gomez, Radio Gambia.
No, is it radio announcer? Or is it Radio Gambia?
Radio announcer, yes.
Yes, it's radio announcer.
Juma?
Yes.
Peter Gomez.
Peter Gomez.
The Point newspaper.
Juma?
State again.
Pap Sen.
Point newspaper.
Madi Cisse.
Anim Madi Cisse.
Journalist.
Journalist Fatou Jaumane.
Journalist Fatou Jaumane.
Babacar
Ismail Blessed
Jan,
U.S.
Babacar
Blessed Jan, Ismail Jan, U.N.
Member, U.N.
U.N. Yes, Modu Cisse, U.N.
Modu Cisse, what's the name of U.N.?
Ablaye Kande, Senegal.
Ablaye Balde, Senegal.
Fode Makalo.
Yeah, Fode Makalo, you're following me.
Korosala, Sweden.
Korosala, Sweden.
Correct?
Yes.
Correct?
Well, I'm good.
Yes.
Go ahead.
Okay,
yes, it's not clear here. I cannot read
it. It's Lieutenant Yankuba Baji.
Lieutenant yes. Yankuba Baji.
Formerly?
Kanilai Camp Commander.
Kanilai Post.
Kanilai Post.
Yes.
Okay. Yes.
Momodou Lamine Sidat Diop. Bakar Njai.
No. Dr. Sirif Cisse. Again, a second time.
Ha.
Go ahead.
Mr. Bakar Njai.
Yes, continue. Mr. Bakary Njai, what followed?
Gamtel.
Formerly of Gamtel. Correct?
Formerly member of Gamtel.
Yes.
And then?
Jibril Jabate, USA.
Mm-hmm. Jibril Jabate, member America.
Last one, I don't know who is Modlami.
It's not clear.
To Alabama Mansenia.
Yes.
Okay.
So let me make this point very clear here.
Yes.
You see, there was a time they formed NAD. Now, is it the coalition government?
Not a government, a coalition party.
What sort of party alone, the coalition party?
Government NAD.
If these were people who are going to come to form a government agency, like when you go to campaign.
Ni mumo leti meno pareta non pruni ilota yaman sakunda alundi atakama wole wulta kampenyo la lanke na maro.
Yes, so you have to make so he can do it in powers. Here, let me make it clear. It wasn't to kill them, but to make sure so they will never come together and form a coalition agency.
Bitunga la fero munu menti wole mnyintiko. Abe kule taman la mea lonko ni mwolu tesilo sotona puru ise benka kampenyo ke puri bate ulindi la nyame.
Mr. Witness, was Ablaye Wada going to be in a coalition with any one of these people?
But he said, for Ablaye Wada, for the fanabe kaya mwolu mea lonko wa, nimi better la kuwa lesun kilimba.
Was Sana Sabali going to be in a coalition with any of these people?
Sana Sabali dun fo fanam betar lañu ko alé sono kono
ba. Council, if you allow me to talk, I can explain every single thing in detail.
Ne silo dina mba be satan.
No, what I notice is sometimes you backtrack from things that you have said.
Na men koro so mo do le kuma wol ka kuma do lu fo bari kana muru ibu kana songolula.
Mr. Witness, the information you gave me was that he wanted these people to die spiritually, to be killed spiritually.
No, because what I'm saying, there are evidences, please.
Look, if it was just to keep their mouths, why would these sherings, these marabouts, call you to check whether you have a relative in the list? If it is, was just
that's
to keep their
mouths
shut.
No,
I said, some people,
seasons,
it was never to kill, whatever happened to them, but it would, because, listen, when Jam, in fact, he was advised in a million years, let him never, ever arrest Lawyer Dabo. Because as long as Lawyer Dabo is free, there will never be coalition in Gambia.
Amonde akubaka umem fole mnyindi ko ni Lawyer Dabo frita ba fambulu woto sayin coalition woto sotono la Gambia.
Yes, he was giving that advice in a million years. At the same time, you know, Fatoumata Tambadja, when he came out, I spoke to some people. I said, this is the end of Jammeh, because he was giving the advice, there will come out a lady, let him, you know what I mean, if that lady come out of campaign, he can let him do everything possible to make sure he get lady on his side. If not, that's end of his regime.
Itu mana tak ke wala mnyinti ko brim farmata tamba jam fintita kenema nga nyinta fanga nyina mita ko woto jam mela wato bantale katu ni muso fintita hanfo e inindol ye nyomo e kambe ngoketa ate muntate la kulbe dal na wala
but the thing is the point I am making is
the point o mem findin ni gam foka
what you told me
ite yemem fonte.
Yes.
Was that this list
were
the list of his worst enemies, correct?
Sir, like I said, Edward David Singate, Yaja may never seen as an enemy. In fact, yeah, I can tell you even why how Edward got dismissed, if you allow me to explain.
No.
That
is not so relevant. Let's stick to this point, yes, and sir. We finish it and we moved on. You told me out of the commission hearing that this is the list of his worst enemies.
Yeah, infonye commission wato mandra siyo kono folo ko nyinle mol told me yan ko nyinne wata jawuldi.
He didn't see them, all of them, as people. Some are his enemies, yes, but some are opposition that he don't want them ever to come together to form a party against them. That's what I'm saying.
This one is there. Bari dolu wolam nyintiko amalla fi woliye kafu nyoma yeden na pati olondi purkate kelendi politiko la karola purka boyindi
is it he was advised if Lawyer Dabo, as long as Lawyer Dabo is free there will never be a coalition. That's the way that Lawyer Dabo, that was the end of his story.
We are going to a different topic. Let's stick to this issue. The purpose of this list is that he wanted these people neutralized because they were an inconvenience to him, correct?
No, sir.
Well, that's not what you said. Okay, let me read out our conversation. When this issue of this list came up,
well,
this is what you said. These are the people who he thinks were his worst enemies. That is from you.
Yes.
You had previously told me that he wanted them dead. That's why he gave the names to his marabouts. And the marabouts call you to check whether there is any of your relative on the list. And for that reason, I sent you a message. And I said he wanted them killed. And then you said, you gave me a correction, spiritually. So clearly,
Okay. Clearly,
what the information you gave me was that he wanted these people dead spiritually. And that is why there is no direct connection between people on the list. It's just a...
We can have a push and pull on here. Why would Jammeh want Blessed Jan to be killed spiritually, or Gaddafi and other people? What I'm trying to tell you here is simple.
Did you expect that Blessed Jan would be in a coalition with Maifati? Did you believe that Blessed Jan was going to be in a coalition with Mamadou Kadhi Cham? Just a moment. Did you believe that Blessed Jan was going to be in a coalition with Samuel Sarr, Minister of Senegal? Do you believe that Blessed Jan was going to be in coalition with President Blaise Compaoré? Do you believe that he was going to be in coalition with Idrissa Seck? Do you believe that he was going to be in coalition with Antoumane Gueye, who never dabbled in politics? Do you believe that he was going to be in coalition with Ansoumane Koudjabi? Do you believe that he was going to be in coalition with Mustapha James Koudjabi? Do you believe that he's going to be be in collision with Sidi Ajata. This is a mumbo jumbo list of all sorts of people.
You have your own belief. Allow me to explain every single thing. If I said on the text and you don't want me to say exactly and explain, the text was a shortening. You gave up, you want them killed. I said, no, spiritually. But here I'm telling you, not everyone who was on that list. And I said, I'll take an example. Chongan, Jame, with anything, anytime you talk, highly of Chongan.
Who
is one of the most honest police officers I've seen.
Yes.
And then,
but Yaya Jame hated Chongan. He hated Chongan.
Yeah, Jame, Chongan are condemned.
If people say that, what I do know is we did have conversations.
He admired him, but he hated him.
People, we always talk about them, highly of them, please.
Yes.
He even said openly on TV, everyone heard it.
He admired him, yet he hated him.
Well, I'm not the same person.
He said he's the most honest person
he's
ever worked with.
Okay. Or rather, he envied him. Okay. All right. Who in this list did he want dead?
The list. Who
was
number one?
So Kukai was to die. Next, Panderimbay, was he to die?
No, stop
talking about him at all.
But that shows his visceral hatred for Panderi.
Well, because at the time, we all knew Panderi at the time, he was always on top of Jam.
Counsel and witness, can you just give maybe a minute or two
for the interpreters?
To just give a gist of what list you're talking about. I think the people need to know.
Yes. Well,
exactly
here
what
is a list. Let me help.
Or maybe you can
give them,
help them.
Give them. Here is a list.
Good.
A 3-page document. And is a list handwritten by Jame. And he's named a lot of individuals. About close to 40. Or a little more, whom, according to the witness, when he first spoke to me, these people were Jame's worst enemies.
He sees them as his enemies, yes.
He wanted them dead. Spiritually.
No, just a moment.
I'm just recapping. So he prepared this list and gave it to his marabouts. When the marabouts received the document, they called him and explain to him that they have received this list from Jame. Whether or not he has any relative on the list. So he took the list from them and refused to give it back to them. So he kept the document. And he kept it with someone who was able to send it back to us for the purposes of this hearing. The witness now says that everybody in the list was meant to die spiritually. There were some in the list whose names, whose mouths were just meant to be zipped so that they wouldn't go about talking about Jame. I see you shaking your head. Are you shaking it in agreement? Thank you very much. Thank you.
That's a good summary.
Now I want you to tell the commission who was meant to die and whose mouths were meant to be zipped.
Panderimbay was not to talk about him anymore.
Panderi was zip mouth.
Panderi, wala nyinto kana kuma fwala kwoto.
Any opposition member being named there was never, so that they will never ever come together to form a coalition agency.
Okay.
Opposition molo menu fanalu tolu fota je pour wolu nenekana nyomoy ka kafu nyoma pour ici lo ka feroke pour kate boyindi.
And
any Senegalese what's the name, diploma or whatever being named there, so that they will never ever have the chance to say they will sponsor the opposition to work against him.
Wala nyinti Senegal en kolu menu fanalu tolu fota je ikana fere soto ikana sila soto nyao nyandi nyama men ya lonko isi kutama ndi mensike makoiroti ite Gambia la Karola.
Because it came at a time he and Ablaye Wade, their relationship was no more good.
Kadu nyinata wato la wato mengateni Ablaye Wade temo we mantara diari.
And then Gaddafi was a friend of Babaju.
Andun Gaddafi fana nata ke moleti me ya lonko Babaju terilom.
Yes, but okay. Let's say, Mr. Diallo. Yes.
You have changed your mind. Just a moment. But you have to.
I have to be very honest to Gandhi.
You have to hear the question. You have to hear the question first.
Yes.
Okay. Show me what in the document showed who was to die and whose mouth was to be zipped.
I can't name everybody because you have so many.
No. Listen to the question.
Yes.
The document contained just a list of names.
Yes.
Okay? Correct?
Yes. Yes.
Is there anything in the document which shows who was to die and whose mouth was meant to be zipped?
Okay, this is, what happened is like when I took the document from them,
bring a kaito table.
I did have a conversation with Jame, and he's always been complaining about this coalition. He want to make sure they will never form a coalition against him.
Ningjame la kacha kono walem nyindiko nying coalition ome bala kumofo kang walem kadeng kapati ilundi upruo nyongo nene kana soto.
Example when they form NAD, you know.
Mr. Diallo, answer my question. You are now answering a different question.
I am not there to tell you who and who he wants to die. I'm trying to tell you the conversation I had with him, council. He told me he wants to make sure they will never ever come together.
Look, we are talking about your conversation with the Marabouts.
Yes,
because they came and said,
okay, how were the Marabouts to know who was to die and whose mouth was meant to be zipped?
Because you see, when they came, they were lodged at
I want them to show the list. Yes?
When they came, they were lodged at somewhere else.
Where?
Minto.
I want them to show the list.
You know Mataru Jaju, the Rasula?
No.
Well, some people may know him. Most of the things happen between them. You know what I mean? But sometimes, let me be honest here, sometimes I do make interpretations when they come to Jami, yes.
In fact, when this list was being prepared, you were present. You were interpreting for Jami.
But
this is the information you provided before. That when this list was being prepared.
Listen, sir. I said they called me because they have. They also knew me now. They've been coming for long. You see, there are things that he would not like me to know, and he get me involved.
Okay. All right. But you see, the problem with this testimony.
Yes.
Is that these guys were given a list.
Yes.
Some to die, and some whose mouths were meant to be zipped.
Yes.
Some who were never to come in a coalition together.
Yes.
Some who were not to provide funding.
Yes.
So you have a list of people who were not, who were to suffer different things, correct?
Yes.
Show me what in the document was the distinguishing factor. How were they to identify who was to die, who was not to provide funding, whose mouth were to be zipped, and those who were never to come into a coalition?
What I do know is like when I had a conversation with this
marabout,
they categorically told me some are there, they said opposition members to form a coalition. But the reason why I have to come for this to make sure they never form a coalition, the reason why I came for the paper, he said they don't know who and who were there. Suppose they say that maybe just to, for a spiritual fight. That's what I said. And that's the time they asked me to take the paper and then tell them who and who are like, if I have friends there. And I said, listen, I knew people here, I don't even do it. And I took the paper from them. So that happened between me and the marabouts.
Ninkumo jamfatanta kana sorno lade.
But hold on, let the interpreter.
Yes, come back.
No, what happens is if
he has already interpreted.
He has interpreted.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Yeah.
Mr. Witness, I have asked you this question. But perhaps before then, let me just ask the cameraman to show the list on the screen so that people would have an idea.
You saw it on WhatsApp. I do have the list.
Yes. I mean, let the camera people show the list on the screen so people would see what is the subject of the conversation.
Yes. Ovi Van,
please pick the shot.
How many pages there, Council? Four?
Three. Could you zoom into it?
I can clearly see the names of Useinu Dabo, Halifa Sala, PDOIS, Henry Gomez, GPDP, Hamad Ba, Dr. Boro Suso, Lieutenant Landing Sane, Baba Kajali Job, Sirif Ba Job, Pasala Jang, Ibrahima Ismaila Chongan, Captain Edward David Singate, Lieutenant Colonel Peter Singate, Tombong Sedi, Turo Jaune, Duta Kamaso, and then I couldn't read the thing under the logo. Okay, show the other page. Obi Van, pick the shot, please. Yes, Samuel Sarr, Minister of Energy, Senegal, Cheikh Tidiane Gadio, Minister of Foreign Affairs, Babacar Blaise Ismaila Diagne, President Blaise Compaoré, Burkina Faso, Mohamed Gaddafi, Libya, Idrissa Seka, Senegal, former Prime Minister, Alaji Bora Manjang, Hawa Cisse Sabali, Amina Fall Sonko, oh my God, Antuman Gay Lawyer, Abdoulaye Kujabi Dobong, Ousmane Kujabi Dobong, Mustafa James Kujabi Dobong, Alaji Maifati GMC Party, Sidi Ajata PDOIS, Dr. Boro Suso, Dr. Sirif Cisse, Lieutenant Bakari Kamara, and then the others, I could not read it because of the position of the camera. Lieutenant Bakari Kamara, Mariam Jack Dentin, Momodou Kadi Cham, Madike Sipiter Diallo. Give us the third page. The third page, the print is not very good. It would be difficult. It would be difficult to get it, but let's give it a shot.
Counsel, does the witness have the signature page with Jammeh's signature?
The person who kept the document said he cannot find the last page, which contained the names of the United Nations personnel and Jammeh's signature. but I know 100% that this is Jammeh's handwriting. In fact, we have a sample of his handwriting here in some of the memos. We are certain that this is Jammeh's handwriting, no doubt.
Lata ñina ko ñu muya Jammeh la safero di kadu nga sample nga misalo dol sura jana ya lon ko ate fon le kayto dol safé mi alon ko memo le menu tamata ala office ko no lata ñina ko ñu mala safero di.
So with this, Mr. Witness, I ask you this question. What in this document was to identify in these 40 to 50 names who was to die, whose mouth was to be zipped, who was not to provide financial assistance, who was not to go in a coalition, who was to leave Jammeh in peace? What in this document was there to show it?
There is nothing there to show it. But what I do know is like, let's say for the opposition, this is not the first time you've been doing it. You've been doing it for so long that they will never ever come together to form a coalition against him. That's there.
But this list you had given us as the list, the to die list. But nonetheless,
I never said to die. Please, okay. Don't put words in my mouth.
No. Actually, I have produced the messages. You said they were the message, to die spiritually.
Right, but the message doesn't go in detail. You said died, and I said no, maybe spiritually. But you didn't give me the chance to say everything.
Okay, all right.
To be honest here, sir.
You've stated your position.
The
commission has noted it.
Commission ya tale. Ila kumaka.
Let's move on.
Attention, sir.
Okay. There is still a lot of ground to cover.
Just before you leave, sir. Mr. Diallo, as there is no date on this list, do you recall when you were given this list? What time? I mean,
this
what year?
Sometime
maybe
around 2007 or 8. Certainly before election, it could be before not this other election, because he wanted to make sure they will never ever come together to make a campaign against him.
Okay. 2007, you would think.
Yeah, something of that nature.
Now, Mr. Witness, on the list, we can add the 57 West African migrants who were killed in Gambia.
I'm not going to say,
if you want to add it, go ahead, but I will never ever add that, sir.
No. Listen. Listen to the question.
Yes.
Okay. I said, on the list of killings by Jammeh, we can add the 57 West African migrants who were executed in Gambia.
Why?
Because they are alive, and he don't have the intention to kill them. Why would you add people who are alive to people who are dead? That's not fair.
Are you with us?
Abeol le mapuru kaulu fana lulafa ni modolu kameni alonko ila saya lonta yefa ni mbanko kang abeola ma amafa ni list me ila banta falaten wontende ako ganan kolu melufata jang.
I have no say in that. I'm only saying those who I knew they died, the Ghanaian, I have no idea about it. I don't know who and who was behind it. So if you wish to go ahead, sir, with due respect, you can go ahead, sir.
But he confessed to you.
But I
do you need anything more?
I'm asking you, sir, with due respect, do you
need to communicate anything more than what you know now?
You are the one testifying. I'm not the one giving evidence.
I may confess to you.
Okay, just hear me out. Just hear the question. I may confess to you that he ordered that these people.
No. Point of rectification, sir.
Okay.
Jammeh have never given, you know, I have to be honest here, I have to be fair to the Gambians and fair to anyone who's listening to me here. He have never told me, say, I gave the orders for them to be killed.
Yes.
Hear me out here. He said he have been misled by Tumbul on so many occasions, and the security came and told him these people were mercenaries.
And then?
You know, that's, and then he gave orders for them to be dealt with, only to realize most of the things that Tumbul have been telling him in life were all lies.
Just hear me out. Do you believe that Tumbul
Bombardier
and the rest of the junglers, Mali Jata and others, would go and kill 57 people in Gambia and Jammeh did not sanction it?
Sir, with due respect, I can't answer that because I do know people who are sent to Mali without Jammeh knowing. So this is something that is way beyond me because I wasn't there when orders were given.
We know, sir, the answer because you told us before.
Just listen.
These people are branded as mercenaries.
Just listen. Previously, you told us. Nobody in his right mind in Gambia. Would they have killed these people, and Jammeh did not authorize it? You told us that here.
Sir, you missed the point. I said we talk about lawyer Silla and then Jammeh's word and then General Baji's word. I said that. About the 2006 problem, I said Jammeh was being brief. You have brief and debrief.
Mr. Diallo, okay, Diallo. When you, yes, after this hearing,
yes,
go back and revisit what you have said.
For the past 20 years, I have nothing to revisit. I have everything in my head.
Go back.
I do not want to say things that I didn't hear from him, sir.
Go back.
All what I'm trying to tell you.
Mr. Diallo, you have to listen. We cannot just be talking over one another. You have to listen.
All right, sir. I'm sorry about that.
You told the commission before that no right-thinking person would do that, would kill people here in this country, you see, among the soldiers, without Jammeh sanctioning it. You told us before.
I've never said that, sir. Over a million people are watching me. I've never said that.
Okay, all right. Those over a million people would go back and watch the video.
Yes. Okay.
And people would show where you said it. And I can assure you that you did say it. Okay, no problem, you did not. Okay? You know that these Ghanaians were killed by the junglers. They confessed on national television and you saw it, you heard.
Sir, with respect,
would you underline the word no? Because this is an English term.
Okay.
You wouldn't say I know. I heard, but I didn't know.
Okay, please. Okay, you heard.
Yeah, Mwele.
And you also heard Jammeh's confession to you.
And the
security apparatus have misled him on so many things, that especially with the Ghanaians, because a group was being arrested and they were deported back home because of his orders. But this one, they took their money and then they came and gave him lies saying they are mercenaries. Yes, I did have that.
And that he ordered that they be dealt with.
And the Yamarodi Puria Maila.
Okay? And they were dealt with.
And we matter.
Well, in any, the word dealt with, whether it was to kill them or not, I'm not there to interpret that. But from what I heard from the others, they've been killed.
Okay, but when Jammeh spoke to you, he was expressing his regret. Because he was misled into the action he took. Okay, and what we know from the junglers is that, well, they received orders to kill these people.
That's what we heard from the junglers, but he didn't tell me kill, not the word kill.
But Sehu, what you are doing now is you are chickening out from your earlier position that he ordered these people killed.
Listen, sir. I used to make an oath, join the Gambia National Army to serve my country. I sit here today, took a Quran and swear to tell the truth. Whatever word I'm saying, I will be on my own.
Okay. Let me change. Let me change the approach.
Yes, sir.
Accusations were made against Gambia government that the Gambia government killed these West African migrants.
Correct?
And Jame knew these accusations.
Yes, sir.
And that is why he disliked Emma Hart. And the accusation was these were killed by Gambian forces. Did Yaya Jame arrest any of the Gambian forces?
I've never heard about it.
Didn't in fact the government cover up the fact that these people were killed by Gambian forces?
Could you answer now?
From what I'm hearing from the TRC, obviously, 100%, yes.
So you want to believe that Jame would go to the extent of covering up this execution? If he had nothing to do with it?
Council, it's been said loud and clear. We had almost 1 week or 2 weeks of this testimony. I was equally shocked like any other Gambian hearing and knowing all these people have been killed here. Yes, he knew about it, because if not, I don't think all this 40-something murder in this country will happen in such a magnitude.
But you are military. You are a soldier. You are an officer.
Yes, sir, I was.
Yes,
And you know the concept of command responsibility.
Yes,
if soldiers under your command carried out a criminal offense, carried out a criminal act, and you know about it, and you do not punish them, and you guilty, and you responsible for that crime? Under the law of command responsibility?
Of course, yes. I have to punish them. If I don't punish them, you about it.
Exactly. And yes, did Jame arrest or punish anybody? So from there, wouldn't he be responsible for the crime? Under the law you just described?
Collateral damage happened here because he's been lied to. I'm not there to say he let him be responsible or not. The court of law will prove that to him.
Okay, let's pursue that line. Collateral damage existed here. That's what you said.
Yes.
So he's been lied to, correct?
Yes. Yes.
He made a decision on the basis of that lie.
Yes.
That decision was implemented.
Yes.
He regretted the decision.
Yes.
He regretted the consequence.
Yes.
And the consequence is the death of these Ghanaians.
Obviously, yes.
So who is responsible?
I will allow the commission to decide that. I'm not there to
give you the commission.
Thank you very much. We would move on. I know you are scared to call the kettle black. But what do you ega if you do? So we move on.
There is no scary in my vocal. Ask anyone who knows me. Those who know me will tell you who I am. I have no fear in me.
Maybe you are shy. Maybe you are shy.
I am shy. I will never, if I was ashamed, I wouldn't say all the killer of mercy and others. I am here to tell you.
Okay,
the truth.
All right. Okay, let us move on.
Yes,
the commission would add 57 to the list. That would take us to 67 killings.
All right, sir.
Thank you very much. I'm glad that you accept. Let's move on.
And now, I did not accept about other killings. Yes, sir. But
okay.
Let's go ahead. Yes, sir.
And now. Let's talk about the witch hunting.
Can we talk about Fort Bullen and then we go to the witch hunting? Or you want to go to the witch hunting?
Let's go to the witch hunting. We would go to Fort Bullen.
Fort Bullen,
yes.
But let's first talk about the witch hunting.
Yes.
Why was there a witch hunting in this country? It looks like there was a fascination for witches in, yes. at State House during those days. So tell us why.
Okay.
We have heard about the story of Cisse Bujiling.
Interpreters.
Yes, so what happened, I heard people saying these witches, witch hunters were from Guinea-Conakry. They were not.
Yes, proceed. Mandinka interpretation. I have heard that these witches are from Guinea Conakry. No, they are not. No, but that is not true. Proceed, please.
These people were, they are Guineans by nationality, but they were in Tambacounda in Senegal.
And then
they were introduced to Solo Bojan through the former deputy commissioner of URR. I can't remember this name. He's a small guy.
Mole yedin Solo Bojan yitandi nyola meya lonko. Wole mukumandango nolanko tinum base banko kang. Nyinata amari tolalde moringole morin doyaringo. Bari wole ni Solo Bojan yitandi nyola.
Can I go ahead?
Yes, go ahead.
So one day we went to Canada. In fact, I was not supposed to go, and Jamie asked me to join the convoy.
Lunkiling nyantala kanilai. Ndema nyantala nunde bari Jamie fongole ko ngakafu convoy o mamolu meni alonko lebitaji.
We were at the four houses. There's a place I think you guys have been there. Four houses in Canilai.
Four houses. Wale bunna no be dami.
And then we were having barbecue.
Be barbecue la je wale subujani kani mi kusubujani kani mi.
Solo Bojan came.
Could you take that again, sir?
Amuru ni kwa baba nkore kwa kuma kawani.
Solo Bojan came.
No. Could you go one step backwards?
Kwa muru domani kwa.
Kwa simfa kilinda kuma.
We were having barbecue.
Mbe subujani nyimo le laji subujani re nyimo.
Proceed.
Solo Bojan came with these people. They went inside one the third. It's not in the four houses, but there is another third house there. They went inside there with Jamie and these people.
Bungol menu bije bung sabanjango bije dame ya lonko Solo Bojan na bankero to nyimo idunta bungole kono ngamira ini Jamie le dunta je.
So. They start talking, and then there was a problem of misinterpretation. I happen to be somebody who can speak Jola, Mandinka, Wolof, and Fula. So they call on me to come and interpret between them. So these people were telling him, like, if they have drums, if they drum the drums, like, if they hit, start doing their drummings.
Nyimolu ba fokanjele ko niye la tantangu lusoto.
Niye la tantangu damuta kakosi.
Niye la tantangu koso damuta.
Wherever a witch is, he or she will come.
Buabe Dawoda, Nitali Lao Tantangolum Kosi, Bua Tantangolem, Buabe Dawoda, Befintilan.
So this becomes very interesting, even to me, to be honest.
Bitung Ninkuana takem kuti meye molu sola, haninta fango, akwayon sola.
So Jamme asked them solo to take them to Kanilai.
Utumwalen Jamme nata nyumfo solo yokwesi kweye samba Kanilai.
Why?
Muneo sabu.
And he said to tell the villagers, there is a meeting, he himself is coming.
Kwe mbegube kiri mbarate fango abinalale.
So soldiers were assigned to go and give them protection.
Bitu ye sojaro lutombo menu nyanta tala katanyi mulu kanta.
And who were these soldiers?
Tumale mnyu sojaro ulti.
At that time, I cannot name soldiers because there were many soldiers for the first day.
Potembo de ntafo nola menu mkato sojaro jamale bije nungu kabirungo lungula.
Was Soloboja bojan there?
Soloboja mbenu njele ba?
Soloboja was there, yes.
Soloboja mbijele.
Who else could you remember?
Hakilosi jumala fana tuwa mudano.
Myself, I was there.
I can't fong bije.
And who else?
Aninjuma.
Young Mustafa Baji was there.
Mustafa Baji bije. Ani?
Uh-huh.
Kankoli, he is a driver, he was there.
Kankoli?
Kankoli. Drive for them, abije.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And who else?
And the July 22nd people were there, the boys and girls.
In July 22nd, Kafo Mulu, Sungudu Ningule Kamban, Ningule Ulfanali Bije.
Could you say that again, please?
Kwe Simfada Murukoma Domandi.
July 22nd, youth action group people were there.
July 22nd, La Fundinke Kafo Mulu Bije.
Mm-hmm. Proceed.
So okay. Some of the soldiers were there because we were given the impression Jamme was coming there, so there was an advance team. So I can't name who and who.
Between Yanine and telling a Soviet and Yanine Miranunko, Jamme from Binala, Lepurka, Kafuimaja, between Aninso, Animul, Barimal, and Juma and Juma.
Proceed.
So while we were there,
Bija to Momena,
these people start drumming.
Was that
and
they
have mirrors with them.
Was that authorized by Jamme?
Yes, sir. Huh? Okay. Yes, that
sir, was yes. Authorized by Jamme.
Yes.
100%
yes. Ha.
Proceed.
So out of curiosity, the villagers start coming out.
Itun kumpo kama sate omolu damuta taka fintina.
Or out of result of being witches.
Because only there was a message saying that these people are Amajambe was coming to the village.
Mumfeng?
Because what more kibaro kira kumiko ya Jamme from Kanale.
Yeah, okay.
Myself, I was in the belief that he was coming, but he didn't come.
Nga mira because he see bota lepa ko atefong nyantanala baramana.
Defong nga lan nosro lepa kanala baramana.
Yo, okay. Ko atefong lata lako abinala le baratefong manana.
So some people were apprehended that they said they are witches and wizards.
Between at a model muta, many alonko ye tumiko bua lemu iti musol ninkeolo.
And they took them to the reservoir in Kanilai.
And inate samba dinkirato Kanilar reservoir mu geolek beo reservoir to jeba mfumunem.
Ha, geolek beo, altatum dami.
Yo, jeela ji dinkirale bije ye molo ye samba jele.
Yes, so even my father's best friend wife was also his elite, but the wife was also picked up.
Hanim fama terima alamuso uyo famo mutale kasamba.
And while this picking up was going on, the soldiers were providing protection.
Soldier only damuda kuruka kanyin kanta.
Yes.
Ah.
Proceed, please.
Kwe ten ten.
So they were all took. They took all of them to the reservoir.
So
here is what happened. Even, you know, some of us were even being asked to drink. Like, I personally didn't drink it.
Utumolem inata fenda la memu mimfengoti bitu ya foye puri yo ming. Haninta fangfang nga minne.
Yeah, but I did have some stomach issues, to be honest.
Bari tonya tonya ayankono mamandile.
So
were you forced to drink?
I drank it personally. I wasn't forced.
Because, but, you know what I mean? But I drank it to see how it looks like.
Imam forced to drink.
But those who were apprehended,
yes.
Did they have to drink or it was by choice?
Well, the moment
they were being picked up, they have no choice.
Bitu yemenu mutawonya wal de ferreta la folia min.
Right?
But what I do know, in fact, even at the building, Jan made it ask some of the ladies or the staff, all of them to come and take sour and then drink the concussion.
Yo, bidungo be kuye kang utumo fong hani do kulalu do lufong lumeni alang ko ebeje jamme yekumani le pru do lufong le na ye nimboro ming.
And for the first day, those who are taking to the reservoir.
Lumfolo nimene imene sambo jidin kira nindo.
What was the effect of this concoction on them?
Nimboro men ya mingani ye kuala ay mun kole akulle sabu ibala.
When they were taken and they drank this. I can see some of them lying down on the floor on different places. And they were not saying anything that makes sense to me, to be honest, at first.
Jamme
asked for them to be interviewed.
Jamme ko ye juma nyininka
wala ye mel mindi ni dimel e mel ke me
pour ye interview
pour ye nyim molu nyininka min ya lon ko ye boro nyim ming.
So I to be honest here, at first I didn't believe it.
To nya aninte fa mallala nu.
But then there was this lady who came out, and a man who said they were responsible for the death of Solomon Jamme, the late Solomon Jamme.
Bare musoso ton taji Mendia mutaninke menko menuko itellemu moluti men Solomon Jamme la saya sababu.
They said that's why Solomon died, in that state of where how he died, because they in fact his body was like in Africa they say when a spider is it a spider like someone they pour hot water on.
Amunta Solomon banta abalajato ketanya menyama ya foko ha itelebulo bakono amunta nin talin jalo ya alajiobo mo balokan amari balajato katinya nyamin bitunga amunta Solomon balaw ketawale nyama.
Yes, a lady and a man did confess they did that.
Musukilin aninke kilimbije iko iteleyo ke.
At first I was ready to tell Jamme that, but Solomon makes sure that Jamme knew about that.
Iko solo bojang ayumneke. Yo solo bojang mampare kafunun jamme.
Akade fa mampare no pur solo bojang yafunun ya jamme ko itonde ba.
Would you allow for the interpretation, please?
Munta solo itele mampare nun kafu jamme. Bari solo bojang tata kuma kan sindiam.
Proceed, please.
Yes, because I knew because Solomon was very close to him, and then I knew he was going to react.
Kato Solomon na katata nyola baba kele.
Proceed.
So when they finished confessing, and then there was also another lady that came and said,
"Biringo rolu yo kumakangulufo musudo fanan sotonda menata ufananko."
He said there was this man in France, and Yajame said, "Yes, he do know him. In fact, he was talking with the lady was talking with Yajame."
Musonyim fonni ya jamel be diam kande bari mo lakumo fo me yalon ko be fo France banko le kan.
The lady said the men have tried everything possible. He said in fact the mother of the lady was joined them to eat one of their relatives, and when it's told for her turn for them to eat her son, she didn't want it to happen.
Yo oto amunta ilafta kule kala nyim muso dingu lanum bang
hani yalo ko muso nyim bama ab ko nyim bama mu quality. So you don't buy the word domole. So you don't like to name for them. Put the word domo. But that man song.
Aha. Okay.
Proceed.
Quite intense.
So he said they did because they said the man was spiritually gifted. But then Yajame, I can feel he start getting angry. He said to me, "Say, well, I know the guy."
Biria Mari la kumo fo. Bitu otumolem amari nyin komole mem fana yekuma soto bari birin yala kuma fan fo a meta dron ya jamme utumolan adamu tata purka kamfa
gato aye go manolo
gato ateyo mari lonne.
The lady said they use their pubic hair as a net.
Eko musonyin ko aya adumatiwo ayoleta purka dada ko jalo,
and they got the guy and then kill him around a castle farm somewhere in Nyevi or in Kanilai.
Tung biri bulo lata marikang iko tumole ya samba dinkirato dame ya lonko jemu ni sila pelulaleti ya fajele
kasu farm
kasu bakasu balingoto.
So and then this made Yajame very angry.
Biri ofo oye Yajame kamfandi back.
He said to me, "Say, you see, this is why phone you we cannot develop."
Ako tumolo Yajame kai bitun seku nko yajele phone nyina nante yirwa nola.
Anybody who have the powers or knowledge who want to develop here, they make sure they get rid of you.
Momondi meme ye fero soto ay londo soto wala afirinta purka yirwa ika ferele ke dron yete mari dabondi je.
He jamme said to me, "Now before I start developing phone, I have to make sure I clean phone. There is going to be general cleaning in phone."
Otumolo jamme kaya nko ntede nimpareta phone yirwa ndila. Woto mbe seneyandiro le ke la phone janka jambe seneyandi.
So after when those people were released, me being a fuller and they, some of them are jollers.
Tumbiri na tao molubula dolube kono wairi jolalem aduntemu fuloleti.
We have this jovial relationship. What I did was to buy colonut.
Tumembe ntema wole sanawiya membe ni tema nte tata ngakuru osang.
And I went to them and pleaded and said, "I'm very sorry, this is never my intention and I don't want to be part of this."
Ntata ke bolosai ngakuru osambe yankwe hu nte mali sanawleti bari nyimenke tete amanke ntela nganiyoti de nte malafala tenu.
And I said to them, "I was acting on orders." I said, "But inshallah, I will never be part of it, and I can help anybody that I can help."
Akwe watumwa la fanangwe yanko nyim kule meya lonko nte malafala numbari bitun silang amanke nganiyoti bari bitun ning alasonta muomondi solata makwe rola nte simembe nkeno makwe roto mbe mari makwe lale.
And to who did you take this colonut?
Andu ye nyimkuruwa sabba jumale ya
best friend wife passed away there.
Hold on,
she passed away the following day.
Okay,
hold on. To uh-huh. Who did you take this colonut?
Ye kuruwa sabba jumale ya.
So the elders, before we even released them, they were there at the four, at the reservoir.
Na samba kebale meni alonko wolebe dinkirato nyi menketa nu oji dinkirate.
Why did you do that? Why did you do that?
Mune ya sabu yoge.
It's wrong. In fact, I will come to that part.
Kula me alonko amanyang.
Andu mbina jeto.
Mbina futa jeto male amanyang.
Okay. What about it was wrong?
Well,
you should allow for the interpretation.
Oh, okay, sorry.
Uh-huh. Yes, what about it was wrong?
I did even told Jami, I said, witchcrafting have been there since the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Say, I can sorry, ko.
Witchcrafting have been there since the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Muhammad. Rubuaya mukuleti me ya lonko. Kabrin na jonyi matilo Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam buaya bekeri nenu kabri otumo.
I said to him, fighting this wouldn't stop it. He can't do anything about this.
Kaya bula karara kukero la oro.
But what about
so
it was wrong? What about it was wrong?
I saw many people lying down, vomiting, saying things that, you know what I mean, I don't even want to know it.
Yeah. Tell us what about the process you disagreed with. What did you find repulsive about it?
Some of them,
they are children. I'm a schoolmate because I know Kanilai very well. And some of them, I've had a very good relationship with them when I was in Kanilai. So seeing someone in that state of, in that condition, I feel is absolutely wrong.
Idolpeje, the dingwa ni munteri mo lentel ni taranyo la karamoro. So ngan wodali lo kan nara naja kukule mea lonko amanyang, amanyang.
You see, Mr. Jalo, we were not there. We want you to tell us exactly what happened there. What was it you saw that you found repulsive?
Mr. Jalo, yajile jam.
People were lying down.
You know, like
when
chickens come out from...
Allow for the interpretation. Allow for the interpretation.
Yajile,
like...
Go ahead now.
Seeing women... lying down, anytime they stand, they fall down, and their clothes falling down. And these people are old enough to be my father and grandmothers.
Emusolje waro are belori bedolje belori ndobe boyla ila fanol be jolon nela ndobe je wolmum ba ma nyolati mama nyolu.
Some of them
I am being brought up in a society whereby you cannot even say
Some of them
see your parents naked. Oh.
Ila wululaje be alay bo alhalo kono e.
So some of them got naked.
Dol bijele ya bije bal ila fengol be wurante bala. I ken se male be lori.
Correct?
At keta wala nyam.
Yes.
Ah.
Some of them were visibly drunk.
Ifang ika dol fango je nyala ko nyinul be dame be sirarin. Oleketa.
Yes.
They did not have the liberty to leave.
Me fan soto kapro ka katara ke fan soto.
Kabo dingirado.
Kabo okay kabo dingirado.
It looks like the frame is frozen.
Sedo.
Are you there, Mr. Witness?
I can hear you now. Yes, I can hear you.
Ako ime fansoto pro is say no ya.
Correct?
Kodi.
Kita wala nyama.
Yes, sir.
Ah.
They were being physically malhandled by Tambajiro and his fellow witch hunters.
Ifango kaje Tambajiro anamo nyolo kamai kang mami alonko amhani nyinya.
It was first conducted by Tambajiro.
But later by another group.
But after Kafudo for Natanan.
This is what people misunderstood. I had so many stories, but they don't understand.
Okay.
I was never part of it, Tambajiro, because he speaks Jola.
Okay. But the women and the elderly men who were there were being physically malhandled and, by these witch hunters.
But nying musolu and nying kelu kebala molu. Minu benunge molie gele ni molie imate kanyame manyame along kamahani nyinya.
Correct?
No, I wouldn't say physically mishandled. All what I do is they were given concussion and a drink. There was no beating, there was no other physical punishment, no.
Ndafola ko yemura ni nyala me anka manera yemen dila ra wolam nyinte ko ye nyin borol dila ya min biri en boro nyin min rong e sirata e be ra bankor.
And they had no choice, they had to drink it.
Bare mahani fero fero so fo kaje ko iboro min
some of them were detained there
dol famu ye sindijele dula kilin
from Kanila. This was in Kanila. I have to speak of what I knew. Some of them were detained until when the thing is from the concussion, like being dizzy and all those of his problems, they are free of it. That's the time they let them go. They asked them to go and shower again and then allow them to go home.
Kapokani lai dole nyin kabrin ye mutaje ye gabri ye boro nyin mi ye mutaje da fo kabrin siro nyin gotela inata ne yebula yete ku biri ye ku yebula ye seita.
Why did they need to shower?
Munat ne nyante kula.
They say that's cleansing up, like, you know, when your powers are being taken off from you, they shower you to cleanse you up.
Ko wala nyin ke sene ya ne wala nyin kaju ka fo ko iba ye semmo nyin te bulle pour ke ku ye sene ya.
But some of these victims dirtied themselves.
Are o mol fami alon ko mantora mol e famol nondile
council. Yes, but you know, let me tell you one thing. As soon as I see this thing going on, I made it even clear. I will come to that point, because I even had a confrontation with Solo. I said I did not join the army to be a witch hunter or whatever. I joined the army to serve my people.
But
there are certain things, like I said, that made me go and buy kola nut and apologize to the
nim toñal de council be fudala jela nim fon nda fon ning
but I'm not going to do it.
Then in solo bo nyafa nyosa ba ko do mandi so ranyin tem ko en ko ndet mandu sojari ala pour kana bua kantola bua de mala kantola de den jo en kafre sojari ala pour kana banko le tanka.
These some of these people were defecating on themselves
molu modolu ikono fambe ike kangi fankan ne.
Yes.
Some were urinating on themselves
dol besum na kangi fangol kan.
Obviously, yes. Very inhuman.
Well, that was the word I was going to use. They were treated in a very inhumane manner.
Wolom kumokti ndifango lafta kamifo. E mata el mi la nyame ngo fango ning manke hada mayati fan.
Their treatment was degrading.
Ila
obviously, yes, it's not good.
Ah, e maral nyanying jawara bakel.
Did Jame see this reaction?
Jame o manyal geleba.
There was, yes, somebody was videoing, and then when he didn't see the people in that situation, but when they are confessing, yes, he did show that.
Ah, modu soro da jamia lonka be video ta kan ka be ibe diamu kan kason ko ye tumiro melle ka ha ibe video kan.
But he was present.
Ara benun jeli ama be kanun jeli.
No, he wasn't.
Ani amanda no ma be rin dingirani ndore.
He was in his house.
Abala bun kono da.
But from what you have said, it looks like at certain points he was present.
Omite ya funya na akatalo ko wat dul ra katara jeli ka ma be jeli.
But
that was if, like a cover up.
If he wasn't,
allow people to come.
Yes, but if he must have been present in some sessions.
But what do you fast in my bed?
Jamme had never attended sessions. What I do know is because one time he drove at the reservoir while the Fulanis were there, but then these people were not made to drink because, you know, he didn't want to appear in front of them, to be honest. So he wasn't.
Jamme na mama mabe ni dingira do dingira do na fan sore waro ni mol be ni reservoir ni ji dingira na na raje abuka la fe pare fan ka mabe ni dingira pour an ni ni nyaay ke naniti.
But you told us that this woman confessed in presence of Jamme.
Mara ya fo jane ko musudo ni ate di amutale Jamme nyaata
lamoy lamoy.
You have to allow for the interpretation.
Oh sorry, it was not in front of Jamme, it's through telephone conversation.
Amanga ya jambe fo nyala kera telephone dia moldi menke dey tema.
As soon as he start talking, Stolo put the phone onto Jamme so that Jamme will hear what the lady is saying, and I was there as well because I was the one interpreting.
It's quite obvious.
Wo mukule timi alonko akakanyo nyamale de.
Jamme knew what was happening.
Jamme kalonne kul mi mbekere.
He knew that these people were being made to drink this concoction.
And
he knew the impact or the effect of this concoction on these people.
Council, we were all made to understand at first that he's just going to let them talk. And then once that lady start saying about Solomon and others, it made us all believe, oh, on the whole, this is true.
Oro ñin dali lo me mu ñin di wala ñin di ko meme yaamin imari be diam lalé adu mbiro mu sol ani wo ke wo diam ta men fo ke ta diam lalti bitun telefona be lata ko la ñi wala ñama.
Where video records being kept?
Are
they taking?
Yes.
Ha, be video lu taka nenu.
And these videos were sent to Jamme to watch.
No video ya kia Jamme ali prase jibe.
Hade.
So obviously he knew what was the impact of these concoctions on the victims.
Rabole nyama ya lonne ni mboro ni niya ming munebet munebe na kela.
So in effect he knew, he saw things that made you feel that what was going on was degrading and inhumane.
And nga alonne ko etole minje ko mukulete mi alon ka
mo nyo nyo Mr. Witness, you know Mr. Witness, you playing this game.
No.
You playing this game. Just hold a second.
Explain.
Just hold a second.
Se do la moy drone.
You playing this game. You see,
I am not playing this.
You playing this game whereby just hear me out.
I'm here to tell the truth.
You playing this game whereby whenever it is there is evidence to blame Jamme, you try to dodge away from it.
But
you agreed that, just hear me out. You agreed that video recording was kept.
Yes.
And it was given to Jamme.
Yes.
And he watched them. And then you want to tell us now that Jamme did not see the things that made you feel that what was going on was inhumane? You want us to believe that? When he watched the videos?
Okay.
And ask me how.
How?
When people drink this, whatever the behavior they are doing, when they are doing all lying down, whatever, at that time there was no video. No video record is being taken.
So
the only time there have been video
go ahead.
When they start confessing.
Mr. Witness, when they confess, they would have been at the height of their drunkenness. Just answer the question. When they confessed, they would have been at the height of their drunkenness.
Yes.
So when they lose their clothing, That would not show on the video?
Oh, what it under the video,
but exactly, yes, it won't.
It would not.
No, they are not brought up at that stage. They are brought up at a time when they are fully dressed and everything, like how you and I, and they start talking. But still, they may not be with their senses. This is what I'm trying to tell
you. So you want to tell us that it is only after they confess that they would lose their clothing, that is the time they would shit on themselves, that is the time they would urinate on themselves.
Whatever happened to them there is no video of taking it. It is just there.
But
so when they come to confess, that's the time the video camera will come and video them, and Jammy will hear what they are saying, and it's being sent to him. That's what I'm trying to tell you here.
Mr. Witness, you know what you are trying to avoid?
Sir, just hear me out.
You have to listen to the question before you answer. You are trying to avoid saying that Jaya Jammeh saw them in that terrible state.
I'm trying to tell you what happened.
You went with them all over the country.
No, all over the country. I will explain as well as time goes on.
Okay, Mr. Diallo. So you want to tell us that they confessed only at the points when they have their clothes all intact? That was the only time they would confess.
No, because you also don't allow us to translate, to interpret. This is the problem.
Okay.
Mr. Chair, may I approach, please? May I come over for a consultation?
I want you actually, if you didn't ask, I was going to call you to come.
Thank you. Just give me a minute.
Okay.
You read my mind. Thank you. Council just showed me five major items that would need to be covered with this witness. It's absolutely clear that we wouldn't be able to do that even if we went until 10 o'clock
tonight.
Therefore, we should meet exceptionally tomorrow morning,
10
o'clock, We will go through these items with the witness. I hope the witness would be available tomorrow.
Sure, I am here,
sir.
If you are completely exhausted, that would help us also. Notwithstanding the announcement and the preparations that we've made today, we apologize somewhat profusely to those whom we had indicated that we would be having our last summer public hearing session this afternoon, and then follow with closure.
Wakono nga kibaro mindi nungo bile nyanta kila na lulabangote na defenko lamoiro ti public hearing. Benhako bila lekin nekene moli katandi lako ama banu nga mefsama ba continental.
So we'll meet him tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock sharp.
Insama somandan si benja talanta.
We'll go through the 5-6 items that council
indicated.
And then we'll follow that with the closing session. Fine, thank you all very much indeed. And again, my apologies to those who came in here on the basis of our announcement that we were closing today. We'll meet again tomorrow morning, sharp 10 o'clock, as I said. Meeting's adjourned. Thank you all.